You're gonna spend $1,000.
Fuck it, man! It's shit!
Mike, how much was that again?
None of your business.
I just had an orgasm.
You better not edit that shit out.
You know what? Saying nutsack is cooler than at least.
What about your ass?
You gotta show up.
Let's just put it this way. Chickens without heads make them look intelligent.
I feel great.
What are y'all doing?
If you're recording, I'm gonna shoot myself.
All right, it is Sunday, July 10th, day one at 7 o'clock in the morning. A nice bright and early start to my day. Trekking up to North Jersey to meet up with Mike and kick off this trip that we have all been looking forward to ever since we came home from Nashville last year. It's crazy. The Nashville documentary trip ended in this same spot, and here we are starting in the same spot. But nonetheless, it is going to be a phenomenal week ahead of us. Cannot wait to see the rest of the guys once we all meet up. And like I said, I got about 2.5 hours to drive, so let's rock and roll.
There's the guy.
There he is.
Greetings.
Mr. Mike Retrospin Vinyl himself.
Dylan, what time is it?
Well, if we're going to document everything, right now it is 9:56 a.m.
And last night, Dylan thought it was Kim. I said I was going to have him try a shot of whiskey of this whiskey before this, we
left. I'll tell you right now, this is an indicator of what is to come on this trip. God knows what's going to happen. So, as they say, blood of Christ.
See, there's a reason why they say do it over ice, because it mellows the taste and makes it smoother as the ice melts it, and that's why the flavor is enhanced with the whiskey over time. As you can tell, you got it without the ice. How do you feel?
I'm ready to go record shopping.
All right, so we are in Mike's truck now, and we have roughly a 45 to 50 minute drive to the airport, which is in Newark, and we will be jet setting off to, technically it's not Chicago,
but that area.
The area, and Miss Emma from 8 Wine Low is gonna be picking us up, so jet setting, here we go.
Yeah!
We are at the Newark airport. Just gonna find where our terminal is.
Well, we're at the terminal. It's just a matter of where we go through security.
And then just kind of wait around until we board our flight. No, it's not a room temperature burger. Instead, it's a chocolate chip muffin. And now we go. Chicago. Now to find Miss Emma.
For such tourists.
Yeah, we don't know where we are going.
Is that Emma from 8 Vinyl Low? My God. Alright, so we just arrived at Casa de 8 Vinyl Low, and we're gonna check out the music room. I'm stoked for this.
Oh yeah.
Here's the singer! Hi, buddy! Singer! Say hi!
He's afraid. The fuck?
Say hi.
He's like humans.
Oh, I see the teeth a little bit. Oh boy.
He's not never happy. Like that. Here, aww. There you go. See? He's not. No, he's good. He's good. He's never seen a human this tall. Hey.
Tall boy. Tall boy.
Hey, buddy.
Hi. Aww. Oh, why do you have to do a buddy? And then you want to see the music? Yes. All right. It's not much, but there you go. Have fun.
Oh my gosh. Of course. There's the setup. My turntable is pretty much the exact same.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, there's the pick I threw at Mazzy during the live.
Oh my gosh. I have the same similar ring light. I gotta showcase the swag.
The cheap trick?
The swag that you have framed.
Yeah,
this
I gotta fill out the top.
Oh my gosh.
I've been playing around with it a little bit, but I'll put something up there in that
trust.
Section.
That's cool. That's a cool flag there.
Mm-hmm. Cool backdrop.
Xander's taking a sniff into me.
Yeah, I told you he'd warm up.
He's getting there.
He's not happy with me for some reason.
Ugh, you need to figure out what to do with those
no.
two buddy guys. Oh, there you go.
Oh, no.
Oh, you see the set list over there, too?
Oh, no. And you're trusting me to sleep in this room?
Not anymore.
Just broke the trust there. Uh-huh. Cheap trick. Set list, picks. Oh, this is sick.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a cool model V-neck.
Is that like Silverbox, like the first three Star Wars soundtracks?
Yeah. That was a good will buy for a buck.
Wow. Which version is it?
I have no idea.
I'd have to look at the album cover now. If the more recent one or not.
Yeah.
Probably an older one, honestly, though. Yeah, I dig it.
It's my little sanctuary.
Yeah.
Oh, I have the same tote bag.
Uh-huh.
Rackets RSD. Cornet. Yeah, the Fred Armisen one. Jeez.
I call this right here my little VC shelf.
Okay, so what do we got here?
Well, right down there in this section.
Okay.
Ooh. Just a bunch of little knickknacks.
I spy.
Rubber spinner swag.
Yes.
Got some picks. I cut that out.
Wait, do you still have the do you have the brown wrapping paper from? Yes.
I don't know where Wait. It's right. Maybe it's right there.
Wait. Oh.
Pull that
out. Oh. Yes. Oh, that's the stuff of legends.
Hey, Xander. I've never seen him like that. I think it's your height. I don't think you've ever seen that.
Tall boy.
I'm 6'3". What can I say?
That's my life, guys.
Is that Mama Marican?
Oh, how are you guys? You want to come in?
No.
No, I just want to stay here.
We're just hanging on the porch. On the old front porch.
I know, hello, darling. That's okay, that's why you got me now.
Yeah.
Outlaw Country.
Ooh.
I know a lot of the names out here. So I'm
who's on there?
Steve? I think it's Earl. I
don't know. Steve Earl.
Steve Earl.
Yeah, David Allen Coe, Shooter Jennings, Marshall Tucker Band, Junior, Willie, Johnny, and Molly Hatchet.
I don't really know
what to do them. I can say them Southern Rock.
Molly Hatchet, Southern Rock. I that was the outlier. The Molly Hatchet threw me off on that. But.
Interesting.
Hey, Xander.
All right. I'm gonna dig right in then.
All right.
All right, Mike. Is this it's a home video? it's getting spicy. All right. Okay. Let's
see. Maybe. Hello, Xander. Sanders on my lap, look at it.
Mr. Billy Joel, Greatest Hits Volume 3, the video. So what is this, music videos?
I assume so.
Having sold nearly 100 million albums, that's pretty cool.
Xander went from hating me.
Yeah, live stuff.
Xander
program start keeping the faith. We didn't start the fire, I go to streams and so it goes. Shameless. Thank you, my boy. Very cool.
Look at
Xander actually likes me now.
Wait, this is an important moment. Let's document
the important moment. Of course, we have to document the important
he's
moment.
He's not humping you, he's not biting you.
He's literally like the in-between.
He's loving you. That's sweet. The whole time.
You know who he is?
Jared's the whisperer.
He's the male dog version of Alfalfa.
We need to take some time here as everybody's talking to admire the wrapping.
Yes.
Okay, look at this. Did you see?
Yes.
Mike, what would you call this?
Christmas wrapping paper.
Okay. That wasn't as intense as I thought it would be. You just said, fuck it, it's Christmas in July, might as well.
Oh, yeah.
First off, okay, let's start here. Let's start with Cheap Trick. Yes, I have this. I have a few copies of this. However, we're going to do a little Cheap Trick lesson right here. If you see here on the label, you got Tom, and you got Rick, okay? There's Bun, there's Robin, they're all mixed in, so I gotta collect them all. It's like Pokemon, okay? Gotta catch them all.
You're welcome.
Vanilla Fudge. I have wanted this album for a long time.
That's a pretty clean copy,
it's
too.
It's a clean.
Take a look.
Should we
yourself.
Take a little peek?
This was my copy that I had in my collection for 10 years.
It feels pretty
actually.
Good.
I owned that copy for like 10 years.
It feels good. You know how it feels. You guys know when something feels good. Come on, feels good.
Just
you
feels,
know, right?
Absolutely.
You know if something feels
good.
Good.
Feels
maybe
good.
We'll even listen to that tonight.
Ooh.
And look at that dual color Echo label.
Give it a little. Yep, it's
give
good.
A little.
It's pretty near mint, honestly.
It looks nice. It looks really nice. And it feels good. Can't smell it. Does it smell like basement?
Smell the glove.
Basement and I'm not even.
It smells like an attic
and
child
show.
An attic.
Where are we rating this?
An attic and
well,
Hobo.
Last year's was rated R, so this one might as well
be
too.
Just NA, what is it? NC-17 or whatever?
Right.
Oh,
well,
that's graphic
news.
Wait, don't forget your
sleeve. Look, we gotta keep it fresh.
Right.
We gotta keep that cardboard.
Carbird. Gotta get that Carbird first.
You're starting to sound southern over there.
You'd be surprised. My Chicago's leaving me, so she can. Oh! I just don't noticed that! Oh my god! I made a comment about how cute this card was with me and Marie earlier, but I just noticed the Rick Nielsen from Jared. That is awesome. Look at that!
That is awesome.
Wow,
now I'm gonna have to keep that. I showed them I still have the Mike Love that Jenna did. So right. I'm gonna have to put that right next to it. All right, we'll move here. Okay. Should I read the card?
I can't remember if it has spoilers. I think
okay,
I may.
I'll put it away.
I can't remember.
I'll put it away.
Honestly, I wrote it somewhere.
What is
ago.
This?
That's Condoms. Not music related,
okay.
But you'll love it because it's two other things that you love combined.
Two other things that I love combined.
So
is it Rick Nielsen?
Yes, I backed him up and stuck him in there. He's a little smaller than you think.
Okay, it's a mug.
You gotta maximize him.
It's a mug.
Edward.
Oh, it's a beer mug. That's beer.
Yes.
I'm gonna be doing this tonight.
Now when you have your morning coffee, you can just think
little coffee, pretend it's beer, go teach the children. I like it. Sober. Very good.
Oh, you're
good.
Totally sober.
So good. Oh. Yes. Okay. Keep the bag. Now, what is this?
It's records.
Thank you.
It's a box. It's a box of calendars.
It's Playgirl magazine.
Playgirl magazine. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. It's a weird flex, but I'll take it.
Emma's on off the market, so we don't need that stuff.
Well.
Well, you gotta get your
pick. On route.
66.
All right, so we just appreciate the wrapping on this as well. Mm-hmm. Always
get some exquisite detail.
Exquisite. Okay.
Come here, Sandra.
I'm scared.
Good.
Don't be scared.
Be scared.
How does this open?
Oh, yeah, it's like urban out here.
Surprise.
All right.
It's a girl.
We're gonna do a live reaction right now. Here. All right. Oh, they're wrapped too. Happy. So this is a great album.
What is that? The Carpenter's Horizon album with some happy on it?
Yes.
Or is it Pharrell Williams happy? I guess we'll never know. Marikin loves wrapping gifts, so.
I do. It's her favorite.
I hate being put on the spot.
Okay. Yeah.
We saw that coming.
Oh!
We got the Roger Taylor.
Yes.
Strange Frontiers. Strange
Frontiers. Nice.
Ooh,
that's good.
This will go right next to
Outsider.
Outsider.
Yes.
One of the surprisingly greatest voices in rock.
That is true.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Really great voice.
Thank you.
Really great voice.
I knew you loved Outsider, so I had to get you my favorite.
Limited thank first person on Red Fun.
That's the first Roger solo album I heard.
Very cool.
It's really good.
When
cool.
I think
it's
Brit Rock, I think Roger
Taylor. Roger Taylor. Yeah.
I think of
his
Oasis
voice is
and
beautiful.
Like Radiohead.
Girl, what are you doing?
Girl.
Okay. Birthday.
That's a great album.
Birthday.
That birthday album is great.
Just
so good.
The opening track.
And then the closing track.
Dude, it's the whole thing. Oh. It's a concept album.
Yes.
About birthdays.
It's a concept
album. About a mother having
labor. It's a concept album
about mother's labor.
Single-handedly, and I almost made a comment about this. Single-handedly building up my Queen collection, and we had mentioned this in live stream. The record spin.
That's one of their best.
Yeah.
Is it? What's on this one? Another One Bites the Dust.
Play the game.
Crazy Little Thing Called Love.
Don't Try Suicide.
Save me.
Dragon Attack.
Yeah. Look at you guys.
Oh, yeah.
Look, Marika's just smiling over there. She's like, read me more.
Yeah.
Read me more. Name
and
all of
it. Has to be mastered.
Don't try.
Hell yeah.
That's the best mastered.
Same that is.
As you, when you got me Jazz. Jazz was a half speed.
Yes, I'll take it from the box set. All good stuff.
There's a theme here.
Yes, there is a theme.
One does not go along
with it's
that.
Not a Queen theme?
No. It'll throw you for a loop.
It's Taylor Roger.
Throw me for a loop.
Alexander's starting again. He's already
helping.
See
on you? No. Now, this is the best album out of all.
That.
Emma.
Now, people thought that was a concept album. But
people
it
thought
actually,
this was a concept album, but it really wasn't. And actually, what's crazy about this is at Margaritaville, where he does the legend of John Henry, the whole thing. The second song he sings
is Emma.
That's right.
Yeah, I doubt
it. Had to be on
but you got to go there on Tuesdays to hear it.
Yeah, only on Tuesdays at Margaritaville.
In Nashville.
Downtown Nashville.
I love Chad. Chad Dallas.
Chatty Daddy.
Well, that's the fan club showed earlier in that footage.
Ooh, what do we got?
Why are you humping me, Xander?
Wallace,
hey.
Their new album, fantastic. Mike doesn't like it, but we don't care about Mike's opinion here.
Oh!
You know what? I came all this way to see you.
Marvelous is my favorite song off this album.
Okay.
It's so good. It's just so catchy. But also, as well as Queen, also building up my Wallace collection.
Awesome.
Single-handedly. She's the one that got me into him with Third Man and so on. Hi, Xander. You like this one?
Xander.
He has opinions like Mike on this.
Sanders thinks it sucks too, I know. It doesn't suck. It's not that bad.
See, Marikin came through with the box. I mean, what about you? What happened? I mean, I don't want to put him in this. Put him in this.
Sanders, calm down, buddy.
Look at that. Emma's throwing records.
Oh!
That's a cheap trick one. What the hell?
It's a cheap trick.
Well, you gotta love cheap thrills.
I hope you're editing some of this.
Nope.
For the record, viewers, Dylan sent this box for himself. So he can send records back home from this trip.
Listen, I don't want to pay $65 for a check bag. I'm sorry.
What do you mean you don't know what Mel wants yet?
Jared knows what I'm getting. He's opening it up. All
right. Making sure there wasn't more tape.
Yeah. I love this album. Such
a good album. So,
where did you find it? And not only did he give me volume one, but he gave me volume two. Wait, that doesn't come up. What is this?
You should have drawn on this. I'm disappointed.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, he's not Jenna.
His big fingers would have been good.
Dylan,
too.
What the?
I did that.
I need the manly men. Okay, thank you.
Oh, look.
But we also got...
Wait, there's volume two?
Volume two. Volume three. three, but wait, four. There's more.
Billy Mays here.
Four.
Billy Mays.
Six, seven, eight. Oh my God.
Protected.
Dylan, what's going on?
Protected to the utmost intent.
Volume 100. All right, let's admire the rapping.
Oh, I know what I'm going to do based on this.
I have no clue.
Talk about filling out gaps in the collection. Yeah, you already know what
I
this
know
is.
What album that is already.
It's no, no clue.
It's a stop sign.
It is a stop sign. Yeah, you're right, Jerry.
I just ripped it off a street sign. I was like, you know what? This will suffice.
Yeah.
Don't just think it's a good album.
What?
Don't just think it's a good album.
Yeah. See, I have an original of that album.
You.
No, but this one probably sounds better.
It's an awesome. That's
that
one of my favorite Stones.
That's one of the best Stones comps. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, my copy is an original, but it's beaten to shit, so it's not that great.
I have that copy. It sounds good.
This one, very good.
Sounds really good.
Thank you, sir.
Of course.
Cardboard is cardboard.
You can't lose that cardboard. You can't lose it. We've
got to
send this
cardboard. Faster than that, but I was distracted by cardboard.
What do you do?
Distracted by cardboard? Jerry,
to be honest, as you're opening, I'm just like, yeah, I bought that.
Oh, yeah. That was like earlier with Mike.
Yeah.
He was going through my records. I'm like, I had.
Yeah, it's like.
Ooh.
I see what he's got.
I almost bought this. I'm so happy I did.
Yeah.
Mr. Bo.
That's right.
I need that.
So good.
That's one of the best.
I still need. I the one other one that I really need is Low.
Oh.
Yeah.
This one's so good.
You
though.
Need Low.
I
that's
need
his
Low,
favorite.
But this one.
That's a top phenomenal notch. Record.
Low is Dylan's favorite.
That is my favorite.
That is one I need in my collection. That might be one of my favorites. That's one of his best.
Oh, just filling it out.
Now that this is all coming back, I know what the last piece is.
Oh.
No. Oh, wait. Volume 7.
Here,
Jerry.
Just take it.
Now this, I was shocked that you did not have. What? Shocked.
That might scare her.
Volume 200?
What's it smell like?
Plastic.
Zeppelin.
Oh.
Is that right? Did it smell like Zeppelin?
I
and
don't
it's
know.
Gonna be. It's gonna be the debut.
Open it.
This is first take, you guys. Villain's about to shit his pants, so I know I'm right.
Oh shit!
God damn it!
It smells like Zeppelin one. What did I say?
I literally can't believe you. Didn't
I can't
get that
believe it.
Around.
I hope you got that.
It's
a party now. I can't believe it's the smell.
She pulled it out of her. What's
smells
what's
like?
That smell
it smells like?
Like
blues, weed, in England.
I can't believe I did this.
That's impressive,
man.
I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah,
that,
I can't believe I didn't
impressive.
Have this though.
I was shocked.
Yeah, I need physical graffiti still, and it's my favorite Zeppelin.
Oh my God.
So. Yeah.
Shit.
I have my mom's
well, thank you.
That.
Of course.
Thank you, guys.
Of course.
You're welcome. You're beautiful.
I love you guys.
Love you.
Wait, Marikin's card.
I cannot believe this.
Marikin's card.
Oh, yeah. I got to read
yes,
card.
Yes, yes, yes. Wait. The card.
The card.
The card.
This was us in Nashville last year.
Yes.
Right, we'll see some more pictures from this year.
That's right outside the pancake place, right?
Yeah. On your birthday.
That was my birthday. Oh, yeah. And then you guys sang. And that was okay.
Your birthday.
Fuck you guys. Happy birthday, Elmo.
I wouldn't have been fucking surprised if I wrote that in there.
Emma,
like,
you haven't had that
I'm
much to drink
moment.
Yet.
That was at 2 a.m.
Okay.
When you woke up.
Alfalfa rubbed my pen. I'm so. Oh, I see it right there. Zoom in. Get a close one. Did you get it?
Yes.
He wanted you to know he was there.
I'm so thankful for the friendship we share, and I'm no spoilers, and I'm glad we're celebrating another birthday with you. Enjoy the records and Jared's little drawing of Rick. Aww, Rick.
I thought
and
I put
Jared.
Spoilers in there. I didn't want to ruin it.
So good. Well, I love you guys. Thank you.
Love you.
We love you.
Love you.
And cookies.
Cookie.
Oh, cookies. Cookies before dinner.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, they're soft. Ooh.
I'm about to bust. Edit that. Keep it in.
What kind of chocolate?
I have this.
I'm now overreacting with cheese. It's really good. I've had it.
My dog actually ate chocolate and didn't kill him, so. Whatever cancer cysts.
Oh, it was good. It was like a cloud.
All right, so we are at our dinner stop for the night. We are at Portillo's, and it is about to go down. Are we hungry?
I'm starving. No.
Are we all hungry?
Never.
Are we hungry?
I'm starving.
Let's
Thank
go.
You,
it's out of order for beer.
So I'm
going to
be serious for a minute. I was like, oh, shit, he's going to, like, listen to
me. I was kidding.
So we're doing a little late night Target run, and of course recently there have been a bunch of titles that are on clearance, so we go in. Oh, wait. I know. That is the standard. There's two standards. Womp.
Did you break it?
Womp. So we didn't find anything. Sad. But she found some stuff. She found something.
I just needed my hair towel that I forgot.
But
hey. That's all I needed.
So Target was a bust. Now
for us, Marie can go.
But
I'm not getting anything.
She says that now. We are at Walmart. Let's see what the final section looks like. Whoa, this is large. Okay, all right. What are we gonna make out with? There's a lot of options.
Cause she's still so close to my reach. In my car, let me call it on. Anytime at all. Anytime at all. So the story goes, I think I'll take you for a ride.
He's
with this money bag by my side. I think I know we're the only way to go. So I show my face, and I pretend to fake a smile.
Close enough. Very sad.
She's a joke, she's a joke, she's a joke. Anytime at all. Anytime at all.
This bar is about to be in for something right now. You're not ready for that, let's do it.
One, two.
He's a whore.
He's a whore. He's a whore.
So if you're tired of the same old story, oh, just a baby, I'm here with you already to run with the changes. Yeah.
Kevin Cronin. REO Speedwagon, Great Illinois Band, Champaign, Illinois. Am I right, Champaign?
Yeah, Champaign, Illinois. All right, it is day number two, Monday, July 11th, and we are going to be hitting the road to St. Louis, and we're also going to be hitting up our first record stop of the day, about 2 hours away, but yeah, that's a little indicator right there. We are indeed going to Riverbend Records, and we are all suspecting that...
We're going to bend some records.
That, well, to some extent, but I think... But I think it's safe to say that this will be the one store that will do the most damage at. What do you guys feel?
Yep.
Yeah. He's not ready. Billy's not.
What did I say last night in the
car? You're gonna spend $1,000.
Wait, what? What?
That's what Dylan said.
Do you remember that? Were you so blackout drunk?
Watch, now everyone's gonna be placing bets as to if I'm actually gonna be spending $1,000.
Just like at Third Man.
You guys are all gonna speculate.
Those TikToks where it's like, who's gonna get the most drunk tonight?
Yeah.
Who's gonna spend the most at Riverbend?
Well, Dylan's always the one who gets the most drunk.
It's between Marieke and Dylan.
I
think it's me.
This is some good friendly competition, but we're gonna have to see who does spend the most.
I think it's me. I don't want to know. I'm gonna spend
the least.
That, you know what, I think that's a given.
I think that's a fair point. That's
definitely fair. Mike will spend the least, but
we have
me or you.
We're gonna divvy it up.
Everybody present. Hey, you ready?
You got presents?
You ready?
It is an exclusive. He's gonna get a kick out of this. Jared, you're gonna get a kick out of this.
Eating his cookie.
Cookie.
So who's our favorite guy?
Ooh. Our favorite?
Our guy? Who's our guy?
Roger Taylor. I'm still gonna Roger.
Who's our guy?
Is it someone that is in the VC?
We're the
road. Yes.
You got it?
Chatty Daddy.
Chatty the Batty Daddy. Chatty the Daddy Batty.
Oh.
Oh, that's great.
Whoa.
Thanks for names. Oh.
I think we'll go with a little Bohemian Rhapsody, gentlemen.
Good call.
Yeah. Yo, just 17. All you wanna do is disappear. Know what I mean? There's a lot of space between our ears. The way that you were taught, you don't feel that there's nothing. Hey, 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 hey. It was the DNA.
Last words?
I'm shaking. I'm so ready. I'm also starving. But
shaking, but. Trembling. Also thirsty.
Let's go buy some records.
Also thirsty.
Let's go buy some records.
Let's buy some records.
Let's buy some records.
Let's go. We're preparing.
We're getting old. We're not the youngest members of the VC anymore. I'm,
we have
I'm
to keep,
feeling it.
We have to keep this.
There's
a couple
of 30-year-olds in there now.
There's
the grandmas and the grandpas right now.
Once we hit 30, we're no longer
yeah.
the youngest
members.
To the record spinner.
The record spinner.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
And that's record spinner. All
the record spinner.
The record spinner.
Yep.
Gotcha.
VG plus, VG plus.
Let's see.
Oh, and Emma, this? And Emma?
You gotta give me a rest.
And Emma?
Okay.
I used Billy last time, so I'm gonna use this
one. Thank you. This one's brand new pressing.
Oh.
It is.
Nice
coral.
What?
Nice coral. This
one's good.
Yeah,
oh
yeah.
It's on colored
vinyl too. Oh yeah.
There you go.
Awesome. Marie, and what was the set total again?
It was like a little over a grand. And I got the 20% off. And it was like a little over eight.
Okay.
It was like $8.
Alright. Okay.
Sometimes people joke. No, we're not kidding.
I know.
So was that successful?
Fuck yes.
It was the amount of gaps that I filled, and that was kind of like what I wanted to do this trip. Amazing.
Hell
amazing.
Yeah.
Picked up great stuff.
How'd you do, Mike?
I did all right.
He's not eating.
All right, so we just left Riverbend, and now Billy and Brandon are joining us for lunch at Chicken Pig.
So good.
Chicken Pig.
And if you ever find yourself in Godfrey, Illinois, go visit Billy. Come grab some lunch or dinner or whatever at Chicken Pig. Great stuff.
And we are going to refuel before we do some more record digging with them.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Dylan wants to record. Oh, just a quick can over of the food. As always.
Get that documentary.
No doubt shirt.
Rocking. Yeah, no doubt.
That's so badass. Did we make out well today?
No, yes.
No?
You? I just started and I'm already
in the red. No. I say no because of how much money I've spent, but I also say yes because of how happy I am.
We're just scratching the surface. Modern lovers?
Good, how are you?
Good. Emma?
Huh?
Modern lovers?
Yeah.
John Lee. Richmond?
Yeah.
So it looks like the party has parted ways because what we have here are the guys
and guy power,
and the girls are in front, so I guess it's a race to see who gets to the next record store first.
Honestly, yeah, with Jared driving, but that's
not bad. It's just
listen, Jared has been chauffeuring the crew rather nicely, and
I appreciate it.
He has been driving better than I think most of the locals.
True, Jared just drives slow and like a grandfather, which is good. It's a compliment.
Better slow than reckless. All right, so we have arrived at our next stop for today, and that is Euclid Records. As of right now, we did find a solid parking spot, but we have yet to find the ladies, so I guess we'll find out once we get in. We'll be right back.
I'm trying to see your saleswomanship.
We need to see the tactics.
What are the odds of finding that again ever?
True, out of all the years I've been looking,
it's time to buy. You've not bought a lot today.
The cogs are moving.
No. Bought a lot today?
No.
Okay, define a lot.
Like, you've not spent like $5 to $1,000?
Okay. Well, if I'm shooting for $1,000 to $5,000, then I've got a lot of catching up to do.
Yeah, you know, I spent $1,000 at breakfast.
Hey, you know what? That's how you know you're getting the party started right.
All right, so we just arrived at our Airbnb, and let's check out the digs that we will be residing at.
And there's a fire pit.
There's a fire pit? Guys, we have to get a fire pit eventually. Thought about it. I brought my pen. If you want any of it, I didn't bring any actual bugs.
Hello.
It's like concentrated oil.
This is where we find the bodies.
I think this is. Oh, there's bikes, guys.
Oh,
there's
what? Wait, we can go cycling.
I wouldn't worry. Oh, it's your fault.
Wait,
I didn't hear the paper.
Emma, drunk cycling.
Drunk cycling.
Drunk cycling.
Hey, Mike, this is where you're sleeping.
Is that really y'all's?
I believe so.
I'm sorry. I feel really bad now.
Aw, don't worry about it.
Aww.
We're gonna be cat dogging it.
You guys are cute!
We're gonna be cat dogging it.
I swear, I hope no one kicks.
Well, you know what? Here's the thing. One of them is
Mike's gonna
one of them is fucking tall.
He's gonna get all the way down there.
We're just gonna hear Mike. That's not what you think.
Oh my god. Unless we set up a bed here in the middle.
You could.
You could honestly grab one out.
Because you could move
out,
that.
And the door closes so that way there is privacy.
Yeah, what's in here? You can sleep in the closet.
Yeah.
Can I?
Sleep in the closet.
Oh!
You can make a little room.
Literally. I mean, there's a little bit of a draft here. A little bit.
You can leave the door open just in case. Yeah. It's spooky.
Oh my god.
That's weird that it comes up and around. And
shit.
Yeah, it's up like and down.
It's like an older...
You know, you're good. Okay. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Ha ha. Regina, go.
It's my favorite.
Bitch, this is so exciting. I'm sorry.
Wait, what?
Wait, no, we're good. We said, wait, anyway.
We've said worse.
We've said so much worse.
Oh, I'm gonna go get my speaker.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is how we get it done. It is 7 a.m. So we don't lie. When we do a trip, we go full force. It's not like we're sleeping till 11. You know, it's full force.
Yes.
This is what we do at 7 a.m.
That's right.
7 a.m. waking up in the morning. Gotta get fresh. Gotta go downstairs. Gotta have my bowl. Gotta have cereal. See everything. No,
whatever the words are after that.
Everybody's rushing.
Everybody's rushing. Breakfast is being cooked up. Everything's looking delish so far. Little fuel for the soul.
Oh shit, we got
Mommy Marie is going ham. She throws down in the
Hell
kitchen.
Yeah. Although no ham is seen on the stove. But that's all
There's
good.
There's bacon.
That's valid. That is valid.
This is Mike's gift for my birthday. So, cue the Christmas wrapping. I mean, it's Christmas in July, okay?
Gold stamp and all.
What? I've never seen anything like this. I mean, I'm a Bob Dylan girl, so anything Bob Dylan.
This is so cool. Gold stamp. I've never seen this. Have you listened to this?
No.
Oh my god.
I haven't actually, but.
I don't even know. With Dave Herman music, Every Grain of Sand. It says 1981. That is so cool. Oh my god, thanks, Mike.
Of course.
I've got some Paul McCartney interviews too, so it's like I could have an interview night if I wanted, honestly.
Hell yeah. No music, just words.
Just whatever.
Just words.
So I got that. Of course. Yeah. And then.
Fuck. Really?
First at Planet Score Records. This is the first thing I picked up that I really, really wanted. It's, I don't know what it is. I got it in the funk and soul section, but I saw this album cover and it's got like this Jar Jar Banks snail looking alien and this like lady, like, and it says Funky Entertainment and it's just, it looks sick. The titles on it are Hot For You, A Case of the Boogie, Popcorn. Like, it's got some funky stuff on it. And so I was like, I gotta try it. It was a bit on the cheaper side. So I was like, yeah, I gotta just see what it's about. Then I got the Complete Jermels. This song, A Little Bit of Soap, was sampled by a lot of people in hip hop. So that's kind of how I got in on them. And then I just kind of continued to listen to them and love their music. So how to do that. I got a little blues comp. I'm a big Big Joe Turner fan. So that's really why I got this, because it has some of his songs I haven't heard yet. But it's also got like a couple other people that I get to try out as well. I asked for recommendations when we walked into the store. The store worker was playing dub music, and I'm starting to get into dub. I have some Lee Scratch Perry, so he recommended this. Lee Scratch Perry produced this, and then this is King Tubby. King Tubby is another great dub like producer, so I got a couple of his recommendations, which was amazing. And then we went to Euclid Records, which I also spent a lot of money at. The first thing I got was Jeff Beck Truth. Emma put this in my hands and I couldn't not put it away. So I have to look, I have to do some serious digging with that one and listen to it. But we've got some Cure here. We've got Pornography and then we've got Japanese Whispers. Yes. I've been looking for this one forever and I never even thought that I'd get like an original or an early copy of this. So this was kind of like a surprise for me. I did not expect to get both, and I got talked into it. I'm so glad because I don't think I would have found it.
You're welcome.
Like, I don't think I would have. Right. So.
Mike and I working hard being the enablers.
It's a good decision.
I mean, those are both great Cure releases. So honestly, genius.
I got a couple Brazilian records. This one I did not know. This one I had a 45 of theirs, so I decided to just get the whole album and see if I like it. Then I got some Sidney Bechet, because there's a lot of him in there, but I kind of just got one of the Blue Note versions, releases, or whatever. I don't even know. He's got like a million different labels that have put him on, so I have no clue what I'm listening to half the time. And then this one was kind of like a last minute pick I threw in. It was in the $2 bin. Little Anthony. Mike said Little Anthony's good, and I took his word for it. And then obviously it's just a sick album cover, and again the names of the songs, I was like, I just need to know, like, these cats, look at them, like, he just knows. And I want to know what he knows. So that's know what why knows.
I mean, I don't know about that, but I know early stuff was like doo-woppy and all that. So
this looks a little later, so I'm like curious what it sounds like.
Michael, yeah,
Mr. Mike.
All right, so I wasn't smart like everybody else and pulled everything out in advance, so you're gonna hear a lot of ruffling.
Rough.
You'll live. At Riverbend Records, I got two shirts and this koozie. I'm not gonna pull them out, but you know what shirts look like. But the koozie's
no,
fancy.
I don't.
Well,
what? What?
Okay. So I got one CD, and it was the only 90s Clint Black album that I'm aware of that I'm missing. No Time to Kill, and easily probably one of his best ones because it has the most hits on it. I mean, Good Luck and Run of English. Good Run of Bad Luck, No Time to Kill, State of Mind, A Bad Goodbye. I mean, do I need to say anything more if you know anything about Clint Black? But yeah, and then I rated his Johnny Cash 45 section. What Do I Care, featuring the B-side as All Over Again. We got Frankie's Man Johnny, featuring You Dreamer You on the B-side. I Forgot to Remember to Forget. This is kind of a double A side because Katie 2 is on the B side, or vice versa, because given it's a double A side, I have no clue. Luther Played the Boogie, this is another kind of double A side, because Thanks a Lot is on the B side, or again, other way around. So good stuff there. Then Riverbend Records, Big Boy Records.
Big Boy.
Big Boy.
Billy Hurst's album, the owner and the man himself, Small Town Fool, 20th anniversary special. He must have put this out back 20 years ago. I've always wanted to hear this album since I heard the Melinda Murphy and himself talking about this release, so I'm excited to hear this. He said it's 90s country based, so anybody knows me. Woo! Woo! This is the one album that I really wanted to get at Billy's store. This is one I went in there saying I'm buying this if he has it. Charlie Crockett, Welcome to Hard Times. If you want a good modern country album that has the old school twang like Merle Haggard, this is it. Jared, you need this in your life. What a sexy album. And I'm seeing him open up for Willie Nelson, and I can't wait to see that show. That is gonna tickle me in all the right ways. All right. This is in the shrink wrap, so but anybody who knows me knows it's gonna be removed as soon as I get home. I don't know if there's a mono or stereo pressing to this, but this is Keep on the Sunny Side, Carter Family, featuring Johnny Cash. That's Keep cool. on the Sunny Side being a Carter Family type staple, but it's also kind of becoming a little bit of a country staple. Has a version of Wabash Cannonball, which is another one of the standards. Will the Circle Be Unbroken, a religious classic. So that's also great. I got one of my biggest Christmas grails for a buck. Andy Williams, Merry Christmas. It's a little beat, but once the spin clean goes, it's gonna be VG at least. So works for me. Next went to Planet Score. And I scored.
I'm surprised you didn't gawk over those shirts. Like, the records Mike got at Planet Score.
I got two white label promos of Johnny Cash albums.
Yes.
Nice.
Johnny Cash the Rambler, which, honestly, an underrated album. It's a concept album similar to The Gospel Road or, that's the only one that came to my mind at the moment. But there are other concept albums he's done. And this is of, like, kind of just him driving down the road and just jamming in the car, hanging out, going on a ride, picks up this hitchhiker and kicks her right out. Get on the floor, bitch. No, I'm totally kidding. But this has a very good song here that nobody probably knows called A Wednesday Car, which is really funny because it's a fun song about how only cars that are built on Wednesdays are the best, and because I have to.
Wait,
the flex. The flex.
There you go.
The
flex. There's your profile photo there.
You put that at the water bottle?
There you go.
So there's that. One that's a little bit more common and a little bit more familiar. Johnny Cash, The Last Gunfighter Ballad, same situation. Waka, waka, waka.
Yeah.
We can eat off that thing.
Straight.
Oh, you can.
And he will.
Yeah.
Ballad of Barber was probably the most popular song off this release. A song he recorded multiple times, hasn't been on many albums throughout his career. But that silver-haired daddy of mine, the closing track on this is phenomenal, too. And then lastly, where did we go? What is this place called? Elusive?
Euclid.
Okay. I got Short Straits, Grace Hits, Volume 1. They had Volume 2 I was going to get, but then I was like, I'm going to save money. Both of them, near mint, you can eat off the damn thing. As you'd expect, Short Straits, Grace Hits. I got Glassinade and the Pips. Neither one of us. I've been on a 60s, 70s funk, soul, R&B kick. And I was going through this stuff and I was looking for a different album of this. But then Brandon, Mr. Hall of Fame, was there and he's like, that's another one, good one that you just flipped by. And I was like, oh? And I was like, let's hear it. I was like, which one? What about it? He said, opening track. Neither one of us wants to be the first to say goodbye to that song. And I was like, okay. Sampled it. Ooh.
Sheesh.
But then the same stuff again. He did the same thing to me like twice, but to be fair, I got him on two records too, so it evened out.
It did.
Bobby Womack, Looking for a Love Again. Same thing, he said, check out the opening track. And I just
made that noise too.
And I just gotta show this because it's so cool, the Gladys Knight. Gladys Knight and Pips are one of the many artists off from the Motown label, but they had a subsidiary they were on, Soul. And this label just looks
so freaking cool.
That is cool.
I forgot the one side, it was water damage to the label, which
still
is okay,
cool.
But that's the good stuff. So
good. I think that's the slogan for the trip. It's
Or going all the way to Emma?
Or when you're in the store, everybody, you just hear all the people just across the store as we're doing, they can just go, oh. And then, good. You need it from the corner.
and then with the occasional, fuck you.
All right, we're gonna start with Riverbend first. I also picked up Billy's album. This is Small Town Fool, that 20th anniversary special edition. So everybody kind of picked this up to support Billy. We got this signed, so that was really neat. We're gap filling. I've mentioned that a few times probably already in the documentary, but finally have albums that I've wanted for a long time. So eat a peach. Yeah, right? Come on, you need a peach.
Oh, yeah.
I put this off for a long time, but finally ended up picking this up. This is a bonus track, limited edition 500. I don't really know much about this, but this was the album that was there from this release, so I grabbed that. Also picked up, because I needed it, Live with Fillmore East. Again, gap filling, needed this record, classic to have. Had to pick up Johnny Cash, had to do it. Especially at Billy's store, that's just kind of the rite of passage there. And of course, Mike put these two in my hands. I picked up the fabulous Johnny Cash. Was this a two-lock? I think this was a two-lock.
I can't remember if it's a two or six-lock.
Yeah, but it's a mono. Excited to hear how this sounds. Also picked up, and you said this one was one of your favorites.
One of my favorites, yeah.
Okay, so the sound of Johnny Cash. So I'm excited to get into his discography a little more. Picked up this classic. This has been on the want list for a while. 1977, of course, Cheap Trick's debut is the best. However, great year for music in general.
Cheap Trick, who's that?
So we picked up the Dead Boys. This is Young, Loud, and Snotty. Dylan's going to pick this up later, too, on this trip as well.
Yes,
so
I need to. I need to get it.
I'm going
to
make him do it. John Prine, another amazing album that I need in the collection. I still need some more of his albums, but I figured I'd start off here with my favorite. We're on a Sunvolt kick. Picked up Trace. This is probably, arguably, the best Sunvolt release. Music on vinyl. And I don't really see these a lot anymore. I see the other ones. What was the one with like the blue cover and the Sunvolt? I can't remember the name. But this one, Low, David Bowie, needed this in the collection. This is the orange vinyl 45th anniversary edition. So finally crossed that off. Next one, Jason Isbell, Southeastern. This was a recommendation from Brandon, Mr. Hall of Fame. And last time we were at Billy's store, I asked Billy for a recommendation. And then this time I asked Brandon, and he didn't even hesitate. He went right to this and said, this is hands down one of the top releases of the 2000s, just in general. So he said like top five. So I'm excited to listen to this. He said the songwriting on this was phenomenal. So I can't wait. Filling up Led Zeppelin gaps, and as you saw earlier, it smells like Led Zeppelin. Physical Graffiti, one of my favorites. It always bounces between this one and the Brown Bomber, but Zep 2. So picked that up. And then filling out The Who, The Half-Speed Mastered, Abbey Road, My Generation, classic, and then Brandon said I needed to grab this too, since I was on a half-speed master. Okay, so I also picked up Tommy. Finally have Tommy in the collection. Okay.
Are you involved with
moving? Yes. Moving over to Planet Score. That was next,
yes.
Right? Planet Score. We got some, always have to pick up when I see like Chicago 60s garage rock bands, the Ides of March, Buckingham's New Colony 6, Shadows of Night. So I finally picked up this one, Attack of the Straw Man, New Colony 6, Ronnie Rice. He's really underrated vocalist in kind of that scene. So very good. Nick Drake,
yes.
Five leaves left. I have Pink Moon, still need Brighter Later, but finally added this to the collection. Modern Lovers. Jenna was excited that I picked this one up. This has been on my want list for a while. It's music on vinyl. And I almost bought it when Target was having that like 20% off or whatever deal they were doing the buy to. But I held off for this trip and I did find it. So I grabbed that. And then another one, Talking Head 77. You'll just wait and see. And then moving over to Euclid, best of the best in terms of guitarists. Rory Gallagher, Tattoo. Fantastic Rory release. This one has Tattooed Lady on it. Cradle Rock and so on, a million miles away. So needed this in the collection. Also filled out Peter Green, Little Dreamer, some music on vinyl, The End of the Game, which is probably the most well-known solo Peter Green release. Everybody kind of knows this cover. I also thought this was neat. I haven't seen this before. Peter Green with Nigel Watson, the Robert Johnson songbook. So yeah. So that, I thought that was pretty neat.
That's sure. Like a later one.
Yeah, it is a later release. You can see he's kind of older there. But I'm excited. I'm assuming this was with the Splinter Group. Yeah, Splinter Group. So a little bit later. And then how to do Burt Jansch. Got Renborn and Jansch, John Renborn with Burt Jansch. This is a compilation 2LP. I don't know much about this, but I'm excited to see that and have it. And then Live at the 12 Bar, a Burt Jansch, early live Burt Jansch record.
So we picked up Billy Hurst because why not? I mean, we're there.
Yeah.
And you gotta support a brother.
Yeah.
Support a brother.
Sarah Simpson, A Sailor's Guide to Earth. It's a fantastic album.
Oh, yeah.
Precious Memories Collection by Alan Jackson, which is like, I feel like it's tradition for country artists to have gospel music throughout their career, and this is kind of a collection of everything he's ever done. My mom loves this album. It's probably one of the reasons.
His volume one is my favorite gospel album of all time, I think. It's good.
Oh boy, Take This to Your Grave. I've been looking for this. And it's like every time that we found it last year, it was stolen or someone grabbed it. So.
Good old Illinois.
And then Street Life. Sinead and Billy Joel.
Yeah, that's a great album.
Getting him into Billy
Joel. Rag is a song.
Yeah, a lot of people hate on that album, but I love it.
It's one of his best.
Yeah.
Like, and honestly, then, Jared was like, let's listen to Billy Joel. So we asked the Alexa to play Billy Joel, and he was like, wait, this is all Billy Joel?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I'm like,
Chris Christopherson, Jesus Was a Capricorn. I had to blame Mike for this one because he's like, you need this.
You need it.
Honestly, that sucks. You and my grandfather had very similar country tastes, and that's when that was in his collection. So I know you needed that.
Polly's Boutique.
Yeah, Brandon talked Jared into that one.
Me and Brandon were talking hip hop, and he's like, you need it. Like, okay, well, if I need it.
I need it.
Johnny Cash, I think it's America
3,
which the American any is hard to find any of those. Yeah. So, and then we went to Planet Score, and I found Acid Mammoth, which I don't know anything about, but it looked cool. It sounded
yeah.
cool.
So.
Nice.
Johnny Cash, I Believe. Gone Girl.
Underrated 70s classic. Gone Girl. Oh, yeah.
And then Black Sabbath, the 50th.
Hell yeah.
And then we went to Euclid, and there's a color variant of Johnny Cash and his blue.
Can we do a live unboxing of this? Because I saw this at every store and was curious of what color it is, and no one seems to
know. I said it backwards, hot and blue guitar.
Can we open this in real time so we can see this?
Well, yeah, you can open it and
I'll say I've got my nails.
And then Flush the Fashion.
Oh, favorite Alice Cooper record.
And Judas Priest. I can't really read it. Sad Signs.
Sad Wings of Destiny.
Yeah, Sad Wings of Destiny. It's hard to read.
Yeah.
It's
down in the bottom. Oh, the Records Today Press, too. That's 30, awesome.
And it's lifted.
Yeah.
Oh, like embossed?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have that. That's awesome.
And for some reason, the track listing is black on black. So
Yeah, shine the light. Yes.
Let's see what color this is.
Pretty blue.
Oh.
Oh, that's cool. That's like a nice.
That's nice.
Yeah.
I like that.
You know what? That's fitting for that album.
Yeah.
Did you go through all your shit?
Yep. Oh, wait.
Oh, you got CDs.
And I forgot Huey Lewis in the News Sports.
Ew.
And Best of Both Worlds by Van Halen.
I'm not a Huey Lewis fan.
I've never delved into Huey Lewis.
Like, so you're telling me you don't have the heart of rock and roll?
No.
With your stack?
That's a small.
It's a small.
Small stack. Small stack. Small stack.
I'll start with CDs and cassettes at Riverbend. I had to get some NSYNC classics because I love my 90s boy bands, and I can't believe I didn't have either of these on CD, honestly.
The only other one you need is Celebrity, and then you have the Holy Trinity.
Right. I also got like a fuck ton. Is that okay if I say that? I mean,
totally. I've dropped that
bomb. I don't even
give
a shit. A fuck ton of cassettes. So Elton John, The One, they just reissued this on vinyl, and I actually did get it. But this cassette is still sealed, so.
$4.
Right. Also, Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, because this is a classic. I now have the trifecta, all three formats. So, Too Low for Zero, another fantastic album that does not get enough love. continuing the 90s boy bands, the Backstreet Boys. You gotta have the Backstreet Boys. Michael Jackson, Thriller. I thought that was super fucking cool. And I got a couple Queen ones. So I got a single of The Show Must Go On and Live at Wembley because
that's cool.
So fucking worth it. And so this was one that Brandon talked me into. I like stared at it the whole time we were there and I wasn't gonna get it. But I had my 20% off and I'd already checked out. And then Billy so kindly gave me 20% off of this as well. It is the Paramore Ain't It Fun record store day single.
Nice.
It's so beautiful. Got one 7-inch Patsy Cline, I Fall to Pieces, and it's got You Called Me Baby. This was my grandmother's favorite Patsy Cline song, and you guys know she got me into Patsy. And I mean, I have this song on so many other records, but just having a single of it was a must for me. Another thing that I kind of debated on the whole time we were there, and then when I was checking out and saw my total, I was like, you know what? Go ahead, Adam. Let's do it. Melancholy.
Yes.
I've wanted this box set for so long, and it's such a good album. Just an absolute classic. I'm gonna use you over
the
here.
The world is a vampire.
Okay.
Despite all your rage, I am still just a rat in a cage.
Despite all my rage, I'm just a rat adding sage.
Ratatouille.
Journey, Greatest Hits 2. I've seen this like everywhere. I've seen it at Matt's and a couple of my other local stores. And I just never pick it up because it's like $35. But, you know, at Billy's, it's so worth it. And it's a double LP. So, I mean, it's not that it's not worth it in general. It's just I see it all the time. But I thought, why the hell not now? because I've been getting into a lot of metal and I just want to add metal into my own collection. Number of the Beast.
Classic.
I mean, what a great transition here. Kitty Wells. this was one that Mike put in my hands. I've never listened to Kitty Wells. I've heard of Kitty Wells, and he says I'll really like her stuff. So.
Does that have Honky Tonk Angels on it? That's her biggest hit. Which
I mean, I feel like I probably know that song because like the title sounds familiar. And I mean, some of these others are probably going to be familiar to me too, but...
But it wasn't Gotham and Honky Tonk Angels was her biggest hit. Right. I mean, you'll like that.
I'm sure I will, especially since you know like what country music I like. This was one Billy had on a live, and I almost bought it, but I was trying to save money for the trip, and so we still had some in store. It is the Tarantino Experience. It's a Tarantino compilation of just songs from a lot of his movies, big hits. I even think this is on colored vinyl. As well, yeah. I can't remember what color it's on. I think maybe it's on like a yellow or a red to match the artwork or something like that. Here's my the one reissue. So Dylan actually saw this and was gonna get it because it was like the only one in store, but he let me take it home with me instead. So now I'm just looking for Peachtree Road because that album is fantastic as well, and I need them on vinyl because you guys know I'm addicted to Elton. Wildlife by Mott the Hoople. This one, stellar album. I don't have it in my collection and I need it, so I had to pick it up. Cinderella, Heartbreak Station, another one. This was actually like reissued for a record store day one year.
Yeah, it was.
And I could never find it. It's on like a blue vinyl, I think. And I'm glad that I finally found a copy. Filling out my Foo Fighters collection, Skin and Bones.
Bones and Skin.
Bones and Skin, yeah. I saw Billy post this on Instagram. It's Billie Eilish singles, rarities, and remixes. I believe this is like an unofficial bootleg type thing, but I really like Billie Eilish. Mike helped me get into her stuff because I loved No Time to Die. That was just such a great song. And so it's got some of her really great stuff on there.
I love that photo on the back.
I know, I was right? Just like, she looks that. Bomb as fuck, doesn't she? Like, come on.
Mike, you
understand? No. Kentucky Girl by Loretta Lynn. I love Loretta. And he has such a great Loretta section at Riverbend. But I told myself I was only going to get one Loretta album for the time being. It's a 1965 first press white label promo.
Oh.
Yeah. And then this one was on the wall. This was also in a live stream, and I debated on getting it. Conspiracy of One, The Offspring. Needed that. Got a couple Weezer albums because I'm a Weezer nerd.
Whoa.
Just be honest. And then
that
This was also in the live, and I needed it, but I also didn't want to pay the money for it, and then I saw it on the wall and thought, why the fuck not? Because I'm there, so I have gratitude. And I drop shit in the floor because I'm me. So next up, Planet Score. I did get a Queen 7-inch, Calling All Girls, and awesome. Put Out the Fire. Two of my favorite songs on Hot Space, and I just needed it, honestly. This is one that Dylan put in my hands, Queen London Battle. I'm pretty sure this is like a bootleg thing. It's Live at the Rainbow, so had to have. I saw this on the wall. It's an original pressing of Stormfront, and I just got the Walmart reissue, so I kind of want to see how they compare, but I wanted an original anyway, and so when I didn't have one and Walmart reissued it, I got it. So this was really cool. It's an Elton John like EP from the UK, Who Wears These Shoes. Thought it looks kind of cool. I don't know much about it, but it's $4, so. Billy Joel Has to Be Master, 52nd Street.
Nice.
Probably my favorite Billy Joel album, if you ask me. Foo Fighters, again, another one I was looking for to fill in my collection. I think, honestly, Nothing Left to Lose. I think this is the last one I needed. I think. Also got Metallica Master of Puppets because, again, filling in the metal collection there. And I also got this Japanese CD of Elton John Blue Moves. Mike put this in my hand. I needed it. Lastly, Euclid. Joni Mitchell, Shadows and Light. Again, filling in my Joni Mitchell collection. This is like, I think, the last Joni Mitchell album I needed for my collection. Got a couple Emmylou, Gliding Bird, and Quarter Moon and Tencent Town, the Mobile Fidelity original master recording. Moth the Hoople, Mad Shadows, fantastic album. I had the Walmart exclusive of Ride the Lightning. This was only $34.99, and like on eBay, it's going for double, triple, whatever. And you know, I'm not even like really like the person that has to have all the Walmart exclusives of these Metallica albums, but
Jared,
you know, I had to get it. This is what, Dylan, did you put this in my hands or did Mike?
I found it, and then I think Jared put it in your hands.
Somebody put this in my hands.
This was a co-op deal.
Elton John, Wonderful Crazy Night. It was originally $29.99, and I got it on sale for $14.99 because I love Elton. This was in like the New Arrivals, Styx, Man of Miracles, a fantastic Styx album.
Mm-hmm. Is that on Wooden Nickel, that one?
I think that was the last one on Wooden Nickel. Before they went to before they went to A&M.
and Tiffany, because this is such a great album and I've been looking for a copy of it for a while, and they're just all beat to shit when I see them. So this one, it was a little expensive, it was $8.99, but it's in really great shape, so yeah, it's great. Worth the price.
I think we're on the
I'm finally done.
Starting off with Riverbend, which I said right off the bat that this was going to be the shop that I would probably do the most damage on. We're on day two of this trip, and I say that now. I don't know what's to come in the future, but this is the stuff where I got the most. Before we start off with the vinyl, I did pick up some cassettes. It's thanks to Mike that he pointed me in the direction of the Kiss cassettes. And I found some pretty cool things. I found this import cassette, I think this is from the Netherlands, of Killers. And this I had never seen before. This is Carnival of Souls. Just never came across this in the wild. And then we get onto some sentimental territory. When I was a kid getting into Kiss, I had my little Fisher-Price tape deck, and of course I had my Kiss cassettes. And I remember distinctively, I had this cassette version of Alive. I think this is an 80s version. The track list is a bit jumbled, distributed by Polygram. But I remember I had this, and I also had a cassette copy of Greatest Kiss. So these two, let's just say, while I was sipping my Love Gun vanilla cream brew, I gave Mike a hug for pointing me in the direction of the Kiss cassettes in my stupor. So pick that up, and now we get into vinyl. I'm gonna need a new bag because I've already torn this shit up. I've said before, one of the things I would love to find is a copy of Sonic Boom. I did. Not an official press though. Yes, this is another unofficial version. I have one already, but this one has the gatefold jacket and the printed insert that is featured in the original. Because what I have is like a single sleeve, just bare bone stripped down. So I got this, and it's on blue vinyl. Also got Billy Hurst's album, Small Town Fool. And of course, he did sign it to the record spinner, which is very cool. Moving onward. Been on a little bit of a Metallica kick this week, thanks to Marikan and Jared. And Marikan put this in my hands, the S&M album. Supposedly, this is becoming hard to find these days. Mm-hmm. So, and I also need to beef up my later Metallica collection. So
that's one of the best live albums of that era.
This was in the new arrival section. This is a used copy of Eagles Live at the Forum 76.
Remember when we were at a Black Friday shop?
Almost. This has been on my radar for a little bit. This is one of those things that it's come out and it's like, yeah, I'll get to it. But for $25, it's open and near mint. I'm like, might as well.
Is that the Walmart version?
Well, the Walmart version has the tour laminate, which is nothing crazy. But
it's so cool though. I mean, they're doing it with Van Halen and Led Zeppelin album.
Let's see. Marie can put this in my hands as well. See, I love having personal shoppers. This is Blackstone Cherry, Between the Devil and the Deep Blue Sea. To be honest, anytime I get a Blackstone Cherry album in my collection, it's thanks to Marie and Jared.
We listened to that on the way there.
Yeah, that's right. We have it in the car. That's a good album.
We did listen to it, and I really liked what I heard so far. So.
Even on the boom.
You mean to tell me that's not Kentucky's Nickelback?
Oh, wait, you guys listened to it while I was in. Okay.
That's
And then this is another one that Marikan had. She persuaded me on it when we went to Walmart on the first night. And then I was like, if I come across it, you know, later on, whatever, I'll pick it up. Because I ended up getting the Metallica exclusive. But this is Arlo Parks, Collapsed in Sunbeams. She said that, you know, since I'm a big Courtney Barnett fan, it's kind of in that same vein. So
the spoken word.
Yeah, stream of consciousness type of lyrics. So. Got that.
When Marie sent that to the group chat, I listened to it right away, and I was blown away by it.
It's right. Like, it was so underrated. Nobody talked about that album, and it deserved all the love in the world.
Awesome. It's cool. So. I knew I was going to get this if I came across it.
Knew it. Hell yeah!
Brian May, Back to the Light. Brian May's solo album that came out back in 91, 92. What was the hell? Driven By You is on here. That's the one track that I know. I think my parents had the CD version of this, so happy to have it on vinyl.
You'll probably know more off of it once you hear it.
Sure.
There's definitely some pretty popular stuff on there.
One of the inside jokes of this trip is, because since Marikan and Jared saw the Motley Crue stadium show, Vince Neil's go-to line is, "Are you ready?" So I had to buy some Motley Crue, and I picked up this unofficial press of Generation Swine. This is one that I've been kind of curious to check out.
Their worst album ever. Really? Honestly, it's the worst album.
This is interesting because
I think
you have the full length album here, but then there's also some bonus cuts like early demos and extra things on here. So it's pretty cool. It's an unofficial press on multicolored vinyl. So once I get home, I'll figure out what color it's on. And moving onward, this was in the unofficial section. This is Guns N' Roses Lies. And this is also backed with the Live Like a Suicide EP. So it's kind of like a 2-for-1 deal. Got my hands on that. And moving onward, this is one of my dad's favorite bands of the day. This is Slade, Alive. I was gonna pick up the album Slade, S-L-A-Y-E-D, but I put it back, but then I saw this. And the reason why I wanted to explore this blindly, I should add, is because it is this album that gave Kiss the idea to call their album Alive.
So, and look at the pretty vinyl.
Yes, red vinyl with black splatter. Very beautiful. Saw this, knew that this was a little bit of a gap filler, but I also need to beef up my early era collection of this band, and that is Thin Lizzy. Basically just trio Irish blues type stuff on their early Decca catalog. So that is what I got at Riverbend. Now moving on with Planet Score. This was up on the wall, and it's funny because this was on like my radar for whichever record store day this came out as, and I think it was the year
the movie was released.
Had 2018 going into 2019. Yeah. This is the Bohemian Rhapsody back with I'm In Love With My Car 7-inch.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. And it comes in this cool split color. Yeah, I remember I was looking for this.
Like, and it was only $14.99.
Which is not like, bad.
It's not.
That's what it went for back when it was first released.
Roughly, yeah.
Right. It was a big deal. That's like a big plot point in the movie.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. This was also in the new arrivals, kind of in the Queen kick, I suppose. This is Queen 2. This is the Hollywood press that came out in the late 2000s. I actually had this in my collection for a while. Got rid of it. got the half speed and then got rid of that, got the box set, and that's a 2LP colored vinyl. This is my favorite Queen record, so if there's a Queen album, I say this and I have like three copies of Night at the Opera, I'll own multiples of Queen too.
You can own multiples of any, have any Queen record. They're all good.
I absolutely adore this record so much. So I got that.
That's the best song on the album.
It
too.
Is.
I fucking love March of the Black
Queen. This was up on the wall as well. This is strictly commercial, the best of Frank Zappa.
Wow.
It's funny, I was showing Jenna this and she was looking at the track list because she is the authority of all things Zappa, along with Mike.
Yeah.
And she was like, yeah, it's all the bangers. And I'm just like, alright. Yeah. And it's also numbered as well. I don't know how limited it is, but it is number 10,832. So there's definitely a lot, but this was cool to
and
see.
That's an early 2000s album, so I think that's way of the press back then.
So this was one of those, holy shit, I can't believe I found this type thing.
Holy shit.
And that is Of Montreal Skeletal Lamping. This has been a missing piece in my Of Montreal collection, mainly because there, in one of the tracks, there's a lyric which is not seen in the best light in these modern times, so they ended up pulling it, and they said that they're going to like fix it and repress it. It has yet to happen, so I found this. I know it's up online, and I'm just like, if I stumble across it, I'll pick it up. But yeah, I've been really wanting this. Of Montreal is one of my favorite new music discoveries of the past year. And Marie can put this in my hands because we were talking about Metallica this whole weekend. This is one that I've actually been really trying to find. And this is Metallica, Metal Up Your Ass. I think this is their original demo, the original cassette demo, or is it?
Yes.
Tracks 1-7, the best known Metallica demo, and then track 8 is the original version of Hit the Lights on the Metal Massacre compilation. Oh, yeah. So just early classic Metallica stuff here.
Jared's is pink. I don't know like what color that is. Like I know it's a pink one. I got it from Roland Rex, I think. Is it
is
the
that
same
so?
One?
It was on Roland Rex.
Right.
This one's on orange vinyl.
Yeah. I knew there were a couple of different ones.
Unofficial.
Yeah.
I've encountered this a few times out in the wild, and I'm just like, that would be something that I would like to own.
You ready to hear James Hetfield lose his voice?
And then keeping it in bootleg territory, this is one that's kind of come out fairly recently. This is Pink Floyd live in a Southampton University, May 9th, 1969. Features just a lot of early standard Floyd live cuts, Astronomy Domini, Interstellar Overdrive, Green is the Color, so I'm very happy to have this. I'm a sucker for pre-Dark Side Floyd. And last but not least, we have Euclid Records, and I would say I was very pleased with what I got with this haul. Starting with the Jimi Hendrix Experience, live at Clark University. This is put out on Dagger Records, which is like the bootleg imprint that the Hendrix estate looks after, of just subpar quality recordings. And for $17.99, it really was not bad. And also came out for a Record Store Day 2010. Shit, it's been there for a while, so.
Oh, damn.
Not bad. Yeah. Beefing up the Early Stones collection with Got Live If You Want It, a live album. I say that because it's studio recordings canned with audience noise, so got my hands on that. This is an unofficial press as well. In most cases, they will refer to Get Your Yayas Out as their first proper live album, but it still exists. Moving on to some Elton John, picked up a copy of Caribou. This reissue was $14.99.
That's
this
nothing.
Was not a markdown. That is the price. So that was a cool find. Got that. This was in the new arrivals. Been wanting this for a while.
Nice.
Iggy Pop's The Idiot. This was produced by David. Was it produced by David Bowie? Recorded by David Bowie and also mixed by Tony Visconti. Recorded at Berlin. So there's a lot of ties between this era of Iggy along with the Berlin trilogy of Bowie stuff. So and also
Is that the one with the passenger on it?
No, that's Lust for Life.
Oh, okay.
That is a fantastic album. But also, fun fact, China Girl appears on this that Bowie pretty much made famous on his Let's Dance album.
Dylan, do you have New Values?
No, I don't.
Okay. We're going to work on that.
We're going to fix
that. Emma's going to fix it. She's going to fix it.
Here's another holy shit moment. This is Of Montreal, White Is Relic, Irrealistic Mood. This is pretty much like in their dance EDM EP. Copies of this now are kind of scarce on this 180 gram cyan vinyl. So I was very happy to find this. And Emma, get ready for the twinning action.
Okay.
Okay.
Get ready.
Okay.
Scrambling.
Find it.
There's two of them.
Talking Head 77. So if you noticed last year, there was some intense 20 action between other members. And then when we were driving on our way, we had said that we did not have Talking Head 77.
You fucking needed it.
So I found the copy at Planet Score, and I gave it to Emma. And then I think you found the copy at Euclid, and
I was like,
screw
it. You both needed it. It's such a good album.
Now that I'm thinking about it.
Michael, you don't have it?
That makes three. But just to tie the knot even further, I don't know why I know this. I think I gave it to you,
yep.
Jen. Christmas, I think,
Christmas.
Was it? Yes.
For Christmas.
Why I remember that,
the
I don't
three
know.
Version.
Yes. Oh. Yes. This is one that I was so stoked to find. This is the last piece I picked up. This is John Lennon and the Plastic Ono Band, live piece in Toronto, 69. Features, honestly, a rather solid set list. You have Your Blues, Cold Turkey, Dizzy Miss Lizzy, Give Peace a Chance, Don't Worry Kyoko. And what's cool with this reissue, and I was kind of wondering why it featured this, but there's all kinds of kachkis inside. There's the original 1970 calendar, which obviously I can't really put any use to it right now because...
I mean, one day it'll match up.
One day.
the dates of the week will be the same.
But so far, all around solid scores, but this trip is in its infancy. We'll see what other damage is to be done.
All right, so we are heading to the St. Louis Zoo today. See some animals. What are you guys hoping to see today?
Red pandas.
Yes, definitely red.
Elephants.
I want to see my people, the giraffes.
You?
Sharks.
For me, I got to say,
it's all denigers, but
I have to say sharks. Either red pandas or hopefully otters. So
Marie
we shall
wants
see.
To see the tarantulas.
Creepy crawling. Holy crap!
I expected more from you.
He's dipping and dopping. How was it?
Great. Cookie dough, mom.
Well, guys, your dots do be dipping.
Hell yeah.
Now, if you take a look here, my long lost family is finally here, all together. It only took till getting to St. Louis to find my family once again out in the wild. Now, as you could tell, I grew out of the spots when I was very young. However, my tongue sometimes does become occasionally blue.
All right, so we are done at the zoo. Now we are at Raising Cane's for lunch. Let's check this joint out.
Yummy!
So one of the interesting things about where we are staying at in St. Louis is that roughly a couple blocks away, there is a record store that kind of missed us when we were planning this trip. And this store is called The Record Space, and we are going to see what is up with this shop.
went to the record space, and the first album that I got was Herbie Mann, Jazz, Good Jazz. I have a couple of his albums live at the Village Gate, which are pretty good. So
that's phenomenal.
It's good stuff.
Leo
Redbone, some good stuff. If you like a good acoustic guitar, kind of Randy Newman type, Mama Cass, I had to do this because, I mean, Miss Marika, and she's said nothing but good things. I love the Mamas and the Papas, so gotta do
it. Is that like her first solo
album? Of mine that I got? Yeah. Yep.
Girl.
I know. We've got Eddie Kendrick's People. Hold on. I've been wanting this for a very long time. It's a little, it's like soul, but it's kind of like low key. It's not like super, super funky soul, but it's like, it's kind of deep and poetic more a little bit. A little bit more spoken word. Ooh. I have a lot of Marvin Gaye, but I've yet to get Let's Get It On. So I had to finally do it, and this is in fantastic shape. It's a gatefold.
Is that a reissue, or is that an original?
It's it's at least an early copy.
Wow.
I don't know if it's an original. I haven't done the full check.
No,
but
that's fine, but damn.
It's at least early. And then, this is the last one I personally purchased. Daniel Johnston, he's kind of in the outsider music kind of industry, and he made all these tapes himself, demos, and then they just caught on. He has a weird story if you ever get into him. But this is his most famous album that I don't have for some reason. I have his other stuff, but not that one. And then this one, Marika bought me, Howlin' Wolf, because I have the 45s and stuff yet to actually buy a full Howlin' Wolf reissue. So
that's good. Perfect.
Awesome.
All right, so at the record space, this next to Billy's store, River Bend, this is the next best store on the trip, hands down. If I had more funds on me, the amount of shit I would have brought home, horror music related, is unbelievable. They had an entire horror area room, movies, movie trailers. It brought the best of both my worlds, my horror love and my music and just general entertainment love. It was I don't even know what to say. It was so freaking awesome. They had Waxwork and Mondo releases that you can't even find anymore, or at least easily, they're out of print. Even from the Peggin themselves, I wish I had more cash on me and more bag space to bring on the damn plane. Holy shit. I put back, for the one thing you're going to see here in a moment, I put back Johnny Cash. Need I say more? You know. That's how you know.
Why not Johnny?
There was actually another copy of that Mama Cass album that I had in my hand. I'm surprised when I put it back and Regan didn't grab it and buy it for me, honestly. But literally, I'll find those again. This... I don't even know. And the guy even gave me a deal on it. He knocked a couple bucks off it because the disc had some questionable marks. But honestly, even if it has problems, one, it's a half decent price and you don't see this. It's the original Halloween soundtrack on CD. The second and third one, reissues, readily available. You can't even find an original reissue anything of this on CD. You can kind of find on vinyl a reissue from Mondo if you're lucky, but no. Thomas Palom a while ago digitized, made me a copy of this soundtrack, of his rendition that he does for me, which I always appreciate, but I had to eventually find one. And when I saw this in the case behind it, I asked, can I look at that? And there's a whole thing in here about notes and conversations from John Carpenter about this, and I mean, look at that. This is a 20th anniversary CD rendition. I don't know if this might be the first CD press. I do not know. I'm happier than hogging shit with this. And then also, what also impressed me with this, that this I was going to get regardless, but that Halloween, I had to put everything back for it, vinyl-wise, but... Star Wars, A New Hope, Empire Strikes Back, and Return of the Jedi, Blu-ray, and DVD, all in pretty damn good shape. This is a 2013 packaging, so it does have the 2004 edits with the rocks, with R2-D2, and the Jabba the Hutt, whatever they did with it. But, whatever. I do have this collection on VHS. My dad had it. But this is my first DVDs, or Blu-rays, of the Star Wars films. And that's something I've been wanting to eventually do. And I saw this, and I was like, heck yeah! But yeah, I didn't buy, I mean, I spent a good amount for this stuff. This might be the most expensive piece I bought this trip, but honestly, you see my reaction.
Next.
I got
bought a Busch Light. No, the store we went to was really cool, but this is what I love about music. Seeing Mike light up like this over a store like that absolutely makes my day. Was it a store for me? Was the selection my choice? No. We went to other stores where maybe it was a selection for me, but not Mike. So it's awesome to try all these different stores in St. Louis area because everybody's hitting different things that they.
That's,
this is why I love music so much. That, just watching people light up.
That's one of the favorite stores I've ever been in, period, for music. That's saying love something.
It. Also, Emma, with you.
Cheers.
Totally with you. Cheers.
Oh my God. I will never stop ranting and raving about this. Oh my fuck.
Makes my
head. I love it. So we went to a record store and I picked up Patera. I don't know anything about them, but I pulled up the Discogs and gave it a listen and I liked it. So we're going to go from there. And they were decently cheap, so it wasn't like a big deal. And then we went to the record space and they had, I've been looking for Peace of Mind by Iron Maiden, and they had a picture disc, but I didn't want to pay what they were asking, not because it was outrageous, but just because I didn't want to do it. And then I found, well, Mike found for me, Halloween Blu-ray.
The 40th anniversary rendition.
And me and Reagan have been wanting to watch this for a long time and haven't been able
to find it. It's so good.
And then we found Aliens. And that's all I got.
We need the first one.
Yeah, we need Aliens. We've
not seen the first one. So from the store that shall not be named, that kind of pissed everybody off, the only reason...
I like that. That was a good one.
Fuck that place.
I think Jared and I were the only ones that got anything. I basically went upstairs to look at singles because I didn't want to buy a whole lot. And I saw this one just kind of sitting out. It's Rat Round and Round.
Oh, that's cool.
In the picture sleeve.
What's
and
the inside of that?
It is The Morning After.
Okay, both solid.
Yeah. I have the full album, but was just a cool piece. Then I saw a bunch of Queen things in the picture sleeve. So this one is just the sleeve, but it's Play the Game. And I do actually have a copy of this, but it's not with the picture sleeve. So I'm gonna like Frankenstein it. Body Language. Hello. So this is really cool. I'll actually show this one. I have like several copies of Radio Gaga, but I do not have a White Label promo until now.
Whoa, let's look at that. Okay.
So yeah. pumped. I mean, come on, we are the champions, we'll rock you. Me, bicycle racing,
holy shit.
One Vision. I actually have a 12-inch maxi of this, but I wanted to get a 7-inch because I'm that person. Somebody to Love. This isn't in a picture sleeve, but I thought I had to have it anyway. And then this is one of my favorites that I found, Killer Queen and Flick of the Fist.
That's awesome.
Oh, so, wow.
Yeah. Then at the good store that we went to, Record Space, that we love, this was like one that I saw just like on a whim when we were about to check out Spirit in the Sky. I don't even know how to say this guy's last name, Norman Greenbaum. Basically the Kentucky Headhunters covered Spirit in the Sky. And once I found out it was a cover, I had to know the original. So I listened to this album and it was really good. But yeah, I have never owned a physical copy of this, but I've wanted one. And then, of course, rounding out my Smiths collection. Had to do it. It was $45, which I thought was a little more than I would have normally paid for it, but I honestly don't find the Smiths anywhere in my area, so.
So, I did not buy anything at the first store. But at the record space, I did pick up a couple things. Some really cool things, too, I should say. This is shockingly an album that I, for the longest time, have not had in my collection. I've been meaning to get it for the longest time. And that is, of course, the debut album by the 13-4 Elevators. This is the recent reissue, which has, it's what? Is it both the stereo and mono press?
She's shaking her head.
Yes. Comes on splatter vinyl, so I'm very happy to have this. This is a bootleg that I have encountered before in the past. Didn't pick it up then, but when I saw it, I was like, might as well. This is called Iron Maiden 78 to 80, the classic studio tracks. This is a collection of assorted recordings from like pre-debut albums. So there's a BBC Radio 1 broadcast, There's a compilation exclusive track. There's Soundhouse Tapes EP, as well as a non-album B-side. So this is all good stuff. If you're into Paul Di'Anno era Maiden, this is amazing. And then this is not, I say blind buy, but I say this having been aware of the album, and that is the solo album by Wendy O. Williams of the Plasmatics. And the main reason why I bought this is because of the various individuals that are involved in this record. Right off the bat, produced by Gene Simmons. You also have special guest Ace Frehley on lead guitar. Paul Stanley plays guitar on a track. And Eric Carr plays drums on a track. And there's a couple of tracks on here that are in the Kiss realm. It's My Life is a track that was demoed around, I think, Creatures of the Night. Same with Legends Never Die. And Ain't None of Your Business was recorded during the Destroyer sessions. So there's a lot of Kiss ties with this album. And of course, it's one that I'm aware of for those reasons. But when I saw it, I figured, you know what? Might as well give it a shot.
Emma, queen.
I'm good at these guys. Okay, I'm gonna block. Thank you. Boom! Bitch! No!
Howdy, Jenna.
Hello. We can do girls versus boys if you want.
That would be fun.
Alright, let's do it.
We got a tie game.
This is not the plan. This is not the plan.
Alright, tie game. Let's
tie
game. Let's see who's getting this.
Tie game. This was not.
Where's the ball?
It's you guys.
Here. No.
It's yours.
Give me my ball. Oh! And like, you know you wanted a shot anyway, no. So let's go take one.
Cheers.
My soul away. Why want to put meat inside this taco?
So what did we call this? White people taco night?
White people taco night. From the grocery store and from
what season
from
is it put
the
meat?
Grocery store and by the grocery store.
Tortilla!
From the grocery store.
So
we got him from the grocery store.
White people
taco night.
What? He said barbecue sauce.
What
like the all of your things.
Like the button. What about barbecue?
Good morning. How you feeling, Mike?
Something about titties. Titties and barbecue sauce. Titties and barbecue sauce. That's what Mike said. Morning!
Morning, rise and shine. How's everyone feeling today?
I feel like if I have a fart coming, I might end up pooping.
So far, we can't
really. It's a sign of a good morning.
Cold. Who's cold?
Breakfast is served.
We'll put it on the table too.
All right, so today we are hitting up the downtown St. Louis area. We're going to check out the Arch and some record stores. The Gateway Arch. But also, look at these amazing shirts that everyone's wearing today. Can you believe
that? Can you keep the record spinning, y'all?
Always. But you know, it's a coincidence. We were looking at our Facebook memories this morning, and literally a year ago on this day,
that
once,
I can't believe.
It's ironic how we timed that. Yeah. How that was timed.
It wasn't planned.
It was not. But literally a year ago to this day, we went to Third Man Records in Nashville for our first meetup, and we wore our record spinner shirt. So, major coincidence, but let's check out the Arch.
So, what'd you guys think of the arch?
Awesome.
Very archy.
Very archy.
American. What was that, American?
It was there.
It was there.
I enjoyed it.
Very silver.
Like, very silver, very large.
Almost metallic-like.
Yes.
Wow.
I poped it. Touched the
marble. He licked it.
No, I didn't.
He licked it. He licked the butt. He licked the butt.
Oh, okay. And to your right is Cardinal Sacred.
Seeing the arch was definitely one of the big highlights of this trip so far. Just the monstrous size of it was just phenomenal.
I wish we could have done a historic tour, but
there was a bit of a wait time to do the tour, so we didn't get a chance to do that, but we got to explore the area a bit, walk around, see some sights. Yep. And now we are going to be going to our next record stop, and yay, that is Vintage Vinyl.
Yay!
We shall see what they got. What did we think of Vintage Vinyl?
Outside of Billy's store, my favorite store in St. Louis. I mean, Billy's is Godfrey, so Vintage Vinyl is my favorite record store in St. Louis.
Honestly, sure. This definitely takes the cake as one of the best stores of this trip. This was absolutely phenomenal.
I wish I had more funds to go with this.
Greetings. We're at the Irish pub. It's all gonna be all right. Alright, so if you remember from earlier when we went to Riverbend as well as some of the other record stores from our first day, we were actually going to be hanging out with Brandon tonight at his place. He is going to show us his listening setup, his collection, and if you've seen his videos, you know exactly what it looks like. Mm. Honestly, I am not ready whatsoever. They're definitely sober. I'm sober.
He is not sober.
Oh, okay. I am sober though. They're sober. Let's go.
Trigger, now he's dead. Mama, I had shoving gun, but now I gotta throw it all away. Bomb, bomb, mama. Ooh, anywhere the wind blows, I'd make you cry. But I'm not back again this time tomorrow. Carry on, as if nothing really matters. I see a little silhouette of a man. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango? Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo,
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 magnifico. No.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from his wrongs. Such a deep, da 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 da.
Easy come, easy go. Will you let me go?
Bismillah,
no. I'm gonna let you go. Let him go.
I'm gonna
let you go.
Let him go.
So
you think
you're
gonna stop me? Indeed, my eyes. You guys just fell apart. What the fuck?
Marie Ken is now going to
So you guys know, when the explosions go off at the beginning, you're finished. Okay. Like, you should just stop.
You're done.
You're done.
Well said, Dalton.
Just done.
You won it, but that's what you got it. The hottest man in the land. Yeah.
That's it. That's it.
Dylan's vibing.
Good morning.
Oh.
How's everyone feeling? Everyone feeling good?
Yeah.
Are we doing shower beers today?
The answer is yes. Because if you guys do it, I'm going to do it.
Wait,
if
what?
If y'all do it, I might even do
if
it.
If Mike does it, I'll do it.
And then if you two do it, then I'll do it.
And then Mike.
All right.
I'm not doing it. Garrett.
A few moments later.
Again, singing, we will rock you. We will rock you.
Wait, whose birthday is it?
It's Emma 8 Monolo's birthday.
Wait, it's Emma 8 Monolo's birthday today?
So I usually don't pick up CDs, but this was a must-have for me. This is the Pet Sounds Sessions. And honestly, I went for the Smile box set, the big vinyl box set, not too long ago. So I've got to kind of do the equivalent of the Pet Sounds. So
it's an awesome set.
Then for vinyl, Tom Waits Closing Time. I have like most of the older Tom Waits, and I need the like early good stuff. So this was long overdue. This one, I've wanted this one forever. This is the 30th anniversary concert. It's like a Bob Dylan, like birthday, also like playing music anniversary thing. And they brought out like George Harrison, Eric Clapton, just all these crazy people to come out and play a giant concert. It's fantastic. This one was kind of a random pick, Sharks. Turns out, I looked it up. This was like after Free had broken up. This is, Frasier. I believe it's Andy Frazier. Is that his name?
Yes.
I believe that's his name. Yeah. This is what he did after when Rogers did Bad Company. So very cool. And then I got Violet Femmes. I've needed this forever. My mom saw them as like her first concert when she was in college. So this is like a good mommy daughter record. So I'm excited.
That's awesome.
All right. So what did I get? I got Femmes.
Got some fangs.
I got Backstabbers, right? Yeah, Backstabbers by the OJs. Their 1973 classic. Mostly well known. Well, one of their most well known songs, period, that shows up on this album is a song called Love Train. Sexy song, let me tell you.
Right. And then,
And I've been looking for, you know, original to early presses of this guy's works on vinyl. I see certain labels, Chess labels, I'm just like, I passed it up multiple times. I want the good. But this one, I saw it and I was like, when I saw the price of it, it was affordable, one. Because I had passed up on multiple of this guy on this track. But I saw the Chess label and I was just like, that's a reissue. But I was gonna look at it because the price made it enticing and well, it's a French pressing, so woohoo. So I got an import of After School Sessions by Chuck Berry. So it's about time I got something St. Louis oriented. It has some of the most important stuff he's done, like School Day, Ring Ring Goes the Bell, Too Much Monkey Business. Brown Eyed Handsome Man. I mean, those are probably the biggest sets off this, but Chuck Berry didn't have a bad song and no one can convince me otherwise. So, there you go.
What?
I give up.
Okay.
Anyway.
I'm sorry, this is giving me long footage. I hope you edited it. All right, Mike, let's finish Johnny Cash, more Johnny Cash with the collection. Put this right in my hand, and actually, with everything else that I bought, the guy just threw this in. So,
that's cool.
What'd you say? What?
Legend of John Henry's Hammer.
Yes.
Is the hit off
John Dallas, Tuesday's Margaritaville.
Yes, only.
John Dallas.
Only.
More gap fillers for the collection. Finally, have Buffalo Springfield. This is the Rhino, the Start Your Ear Off Right mono version reissue. So I almost picked up a stereo of this, probably an early pressing, you know, some sort of early reissue, and because I needed it. But I held off. I'm happy I did because I did want to do the mono. So there's that. Also finally have East West, Paul Butterfield Blues Band, the music on vinyl reissue. So I'm sure this is going to sound great.
I can't believe you didn't already have
it. Yeah, I didn't already have it. And I almost wanted to pick up the Record Store Day, Elektra Sections that they just put out this Record Store Day, but I said I needed to have this first before I bought that. So, got that, so I can buy that. Buddy Guy, Damn Right,
Ooh.
I've Got the Blues, my favorite Buddy Guy album, so good. This was, it's later Buddy Guy, what is this, the 90s? 1991. And in his music on vinyl, actually, I have number 139. I just saw that, so I don't know what it's out of.
That's nice.
That's really cool. Also finally have Patti Smith, Horses, something that I needed. Groundhogs, Blues Obituary, 50th anniversary reissue. Fire's been putting them out and they've been doing a great, great job. So picked that up. Picked up two Burt Janches that I needed. I've never seen these in the wild, so I'm really excited to have these two. Freddie King, My Feelings for the Blues, more blues. More music on vinyl, and surprisingly, not that I don't love Albert King, not time, but I don't love BB King. Freddie King's my favorite kid. Here's a fun fact for you guys. And also picked up King Crimson. This is for Bill. Final verse. Shout out.
And the essential Ozzy Osbourne CD.
Yes.
I'm really excited about that. We might break that open later. I asked Mike and Jenna to find me a solo album, and they found me Sly and the Family Stone, Greatest Hits. And now that I've looked at it, I recognize a lot of stuff on it, so I'm pretty excited about that.
I've listened to that with you in the house.
Metallica, Volume 2. It is Classic Festival Broadcast 1999. So this is probably
as old as I am.
Well, true.
Sure. Grandma Marikin.
I know, you don't have to rub it in.
I'm going to say this is probably right after the Garage Inc. CD come out.
It's right around that time, yeah.
Probably around Reload.
Yeah.
So, all right.
Cracking yolks.
Got T-Rex, Electric Warrior. Have this on vinyl. Needed it on CD. Profile 2, Emmylou Harris. I have Profile 1. Needed Profile 2. Yeah. ABBA, Waterloo. Been looking for this forever. Michael Jackson history. I really didn't want the picture disc, but
that's the most affordable version you could find.
Right. This is the only time I've ever seen it, and you know, might as well. It's $36. So, Foster the People, Torches, such a nostalgic record for me. I remember listening to this a lot as a kid, and this is the 2LP reissue. It's on orange vinyl. It's the 10th anniversary pressing of that. Makes me feel old knowing that's 10 years old. So since I'm still digging into Slayer, I thought I would pick up another one of their albums while I was on the trip, and this one just kind of intrigued me. It's also on a flesh pink and orange marble vinyl. This is Show No Mercy.
That's her debut.
It is?
Yeah, that's her debut EP.
Okay. Great. See, so I'm learning. As you can tell, I'm still trying to figure out their discography, but
yeah, that's before Rain and Blood.
Very excited. I love Rain and Blood. That's so amazing. So I'm hoping I'll really love that, especially since that's debut. Got a couple Elvis records. This is 30 number one hits, and it's on gold vinyl. I've been meaning to pick this up, and then when I saw it was on gold vinyl, I automatically had to.
Sweet.
This honestly, I probably shouldn't have gotten because it's the 50 greatest hits of Elvis Presley, but I've been wanting this pressing for a while as well. I thought I should pick it up. It's music on vinyl, so I know it's gonna sound great. Just had to have it. Americana by The Offspring. I really wanted the red pressing of this, but I've given up, and this was only $34, so. Pretty Reckless, Going to Hell. Definitely needed this in my collection. I missed out on the pre-order. I wanted to get a colored pressing, but standard black works just as well. And then what I've been waiting for this whole trip, Elton John, Peachtree Road. I've been looking for this the entire trip, I'm so excited to finally have it.
Is that an alternate album cover?
Right. Yeah, this is the expanded deluxe edition of the album, and it's got different album art.
That's cool.
Nice.
All right, vintage vinyl. What did I get? Picked up The Best of Big Star.
Nice.
It's funny. I was going to buy the first record in Nashville last summer, which I did not do. And my coworker at the store that I manage was playing Radio City, which upon hearing it, I'm like, there's a lot of like Cheap Trick, elements. So I was just like, you know what? This was the only real like Big Star album that was at Vintage Vinyl. So I went ahead and picked this up. It's got a little bit of everything, so it's good to have. So while we were on our way to the airport, Mike and I, we were listening to this Bee Gees compilation, Best of the Bee Gees. Absolutely loved what I've heard, and I know that I would definitely really like the early Bee Gees stuff. No disrespect to the disco stuff, but this is kind of more up my alley, and it's just nice to have some early Bee Gees in my collection. This is a bit of a blind buy for me. I mean, not blind in the sense that I don't know who this individual is. This is Dee Dee Ramone, and this is called I Hate Freaks Like You. It's, I don't know if this is one of the solo records or just a collection of various tracks, but there's things on here such as Making Monsters for My Friends, It's Not For Me to Know, All's Quiet on the Eastern Front, so tracks that have appeared on Ramone's album since he did write for them while he was out of the band, so I figured get some solo Dee Dee stuff in the collection. This is a Record Store Day release that came out recently that completely escaped me, and when I saw it, I was like, hell yeah. This is Focus, Singles, Deep Cuts, and BBC Live. Some good Dutch prog rock. Of course, Hocus Pocus is their big notable tune. If you haven't heard it, you have to hear it once.
and basically just features singles, deep cuts, and BBC Live stuff. So it, if you're not gonna buy a Focus studio album, I guess this is the way to go. And then going on to bag two.
Bag two, two bags?
Yes, two
damn
bags.
Dylan.
This is Changes Eno Bowie. This is a bootleg. This is a collection of just various live recordings from the 70s into the 90s, focusing on the stuff that Bowie had collaborated with Brian Eno of Roxy Music, and he's done work with a million other artists. And given that I love the Berlin era so much, and Low is my favorite Bowie record, having something like this is definitely was definitely noteworthy of owning. So very happy to have it. Next, Mike and Jenna, you guys will be very happy for me.
Yes, sir.
Frank Zappa, Joe's Garage, Acts 1, 2, and 3.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I didn't see the 3. I yes. didn't know.
You can jam in Joe's Garage. I got no drugs or LSD, but a couple of quarts of beer. Yeah.
So when Mike and I were on the road to Nashville last year, we listened to this record, and I absolutely adored it upon first listen. And I was hoping to find it in Nashville, but it did not happen. And this reissue, which brings together the three volumes, is kind of hard to come by. And for $40, it really is not bad value. So when I saw it, this was definitely like a must-get, will-not-put-back type deal. So got some supplementary stuff with the Zappa collection. And then last but not least, kind of tying in with what Marikan had showcased last, Elton John's The One. When we went to Riverbend, there was one copy there. I had it in my hand. I was like, Marikan, you are more worthy of having this one copy than I am. And I figured that since it's so new, I probably would have found it somewhere. And sure enough, I did.
Hey, good thing we're going to Billy's.
Today.
Round two.
We're going to take you to Billy's.
We're going to Billy's.
Billy's. Billy's. Billy's.
He's going to be like, what are y'all doing?
Billy's Star. Billy's.
Round two.
Round two.
Round two. Round two. Round two. Let's go.
Round one.
Round one. Let's go. What's your experience so far, Jenna, of this shop?
I'm already scared of what my damage is gonna be, and I haven't even gone through like half of it yet, so.
That's a spirit.
Yeah.
So how was round two?
Round two.
What's that?
I spent more money.
Well, as you can tell today, it's a little bit of a light day. I think with the exception of Jenna. But you'll have to see what we got later on, once we get settled back. All right, so Riverbend round two. So I have to say, while my stack was rather light, the credibility of what I left with was absolutely phenomenal. But first off, free stickers. And he restocked on t-shirts yesterday. And I wanted to get this shirt, but it wasn't there in my size and the color that I wanted. So when I saw that it was there, I had to pick it up. And it simply says, I'm just here for records and beer, which, you know, is a mantra that we can all kind of live by. Has the Riverbend on the back here. Very good stuff. I'll be gladly sporting this. So I didn't really dig too much in the Beatles section or Beatles related sections from the first day. And I saw this there and I freaked out because I was shocked that this was still there, just given the rarity value behind it and what it kind of goes for now. But this is McCartney 3. This is the 3333 edition, one time pressing, indie exclusive. Third Man actually had pressed this up, and they also did that polka dot colored vinyl pressing from way back. That goes for insane money. I have the indie white version, which I'm probably gonna part ways with now that I have this. But what's cool about it is that it does come with a giant fold-out poster, and the color of the vinyl is phenomenal. Comes on yellow vinyl with black splatter, which looks absolutely phenomenal. And this next record was one that I had in my hands back on Monday, but I put it back and I was like, I'll find it again at some point. But since we made the trip again, I picked up Quiet Riot's Mental Health. Shockingly, I did not have this in my collection and I definitely needed it, as well as everyone agreed that I needed this album. So very happy to have it. And this escaped me entirely. And this is such a cool piece of AC/DC vinyl in my collection. It is the Australian High Voltage. So this is actually their pure debut album, because the High Voltage that we all know has Angus on the front, and it's kind of like a compilation of like tracks from the first two records. But their cover of Baby Please Don't Go is on here. She's Got Balls, Little Lover, Show Business. It's all good stuff.
The main reason we wanted to go back was to take Jenna, obviously. But last night when we were at Brandon's, we played a clip bit of Jagged Little Pill. Yes. Alanis Morissette. And I don't have this in my collection. And everyone's like, oh yeah, it was at Billy's. And I totally didn't even see this the first time we went. So I said, if we go back, I'm going to get it. And I did. Also, this was one that I kind of passed up on the first time we were at Billy's. Carrie Underwood, Some Hearts. Fantastic release from Carrie Underwood, probably one of her most well-known albums, and I just had to get it on vinyl. Also asked everyone for a recommendation to put into my collection, so Mike recommended Steppenwolf Live. I don't have any Steppenwolf. Don't really know much about their discography. I know some of the big hits, but we'll give it a shot. This was Emma's recommendation, New York Dolls. Is it just too much too soon? Yeah, okay, In Too Much Too Soon. I don't know anything about the New York Dolls, but Emma says I will like them. So, happy to have that. Dylan's recommendation was the Sunlandic Twins by Of Montreal, and this is on a red and orange vinyl. This is the deluxe edition, so it's got 10 extra songs, double LP. Again, know nothing about Of Montreal, except for the way Dylan described it, so. Really excited about that. This was Jenna's pick, Funkadelic Maggot Brain. This is an album I've been wanting to get into and I've just never picked it up. I'm really excited that Jenna made me pick this up. And lastly, Billy's recommendation, Vern Gosden. I feel like I'm saying that wrong. Gosden.
Right.
I think that's about right. Chiseled in stone, Gosden.
Vern Gosden.
Yeah. Yeah, he said this was a good album, and he thought Jared and I would both like it. So, really excited to check this one out.
All right, Merle Haggard, The Epic Collection. This is live, so that's fun.
That's fun.
Haggard introducing my friends The Strangers, which is his backup band, and High on the Hilltop. He had a lot more, but I had to put some back. And then Alan Jackson, The Greatest Hits Collection, which, I mean, it's Alan Jackson, so it's everything you hear on the radio by him, so.
Filling out my Lou Reed, picked up Street Hassle, 1979. Okay, Jenna, we're twinning with the Violent Femmes. I have the one, what's it called, with the flowers all over it?
I'm not a big fan of that one, honestly, but like on.
So she's wrong, but Craft Recordings, this is the 35th anniversary reissue. I'm sure you'll let us know what that other one was named, but this one's the one with Blistering Sun. We've already seen this. Mm-hmm. And then on recommendation from Marie, since we traded off here, I got, you know, we did the New York Dolls. We're going to do some metal. I don't have, you guys, if you've seen me, you guys know I don't collect metal. But Master of Puppets, Metallica.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, so classic. I'm classic. So I'm gonna get into this. I've heard this before. I just
don't
know. Okay, so the first thing I got was Donny Hathaway Live, and this I know is just recently reissued, but I was holding off for an original forever. Found one for a decent price, so I had to do it. This got me last second, and that talked me into it. But I know I'll never be able to afford an original, and I don't even want to try. So this. You know what? It's gonna be worth it in the end. Mm-hmm. Another Emma. Well, Emma put a gun to my head and she forced me to buy this. Oh. I thought I had it backwards.
No. I was like, that's backwards. You're just messing with me.
But yeah, finally gonna bulk up the Cheap Trick.
And then this one was another album that was actually played last night at Brandon's place. No, and I dug it. The second the needle hit, I was like, whatever this is, I need it and I want it. And then I went through the Japanese pressings and it was right there. So I'm like, it's a sign. Like, it's a
hell
sign.
Yeah.
And just even the obi looks fantastic.
That looks cool.
Like, it's sick. I got Strawberry Switchblade. This is kind of a more rare UK album. It's a little cheesy, but I honestly enjoy my time listening to this, and I've never seen it in the wild. Had to get it. This Gold Soul comp, it had like a lot of good stuff on it. Isaac Hayes, The Emotions, Born Under a Bad Sign, Albert King. Need full album, but it's on here too. Soul Limbo, Booker T and the MGs, just good stuff. Good stuff. And then hopped on the Moroccan train here after hearing this album at Brandon's last night. I was like, I need it. So this was such a random pick. I don't have this Police album and it was $12 and I've needed it and it has some of my favorite Police songs. Kind of just threw it in there. That's it. Yeah.
So you would think that this one specific plan that we're doing now would be the one that was the most thought out, but literally the Cardinals game is starting in an hour and we just bought tickets for $6 just on a whim.
Why not?
So
we were trying to figure out what to do. We were like, well, maybe Dave and Buster's, maybe an arcade.
I think we made out.
Totally.
We said $6 ball game tickets cheaper than Dave and Buster's.
Yeah, let's go. Hands down. And personally for myself, I haven't been to a ball game in like 12 years. So this is definitely long overdue. So let's check this out. Guys, how did we get here?
I don't know what's going on.
How did we get here?
We're not even in the right spot. Wait for round three.
So as you can tell in the back seat, we are all packed up. We just checked out of our Airbnb, but the trip is not over because we are on our way now to Waffle House. This is another guys versus girls type thing. All the girls are in one car, all us guys are in the other. There he is. There's the other guy. And yes, I'm ready for some waffles. I'm ready for some hash browns.
Good. That's better than what you said earlier.
You don't want to know what I said earlier.
You even said the Jersey equivalent of pork roll.
I'm hungry. Proceed. Let's go. Proceed to the root indeed.
And for some hot stuff, maybe let's see.
I'm going home, guys. She's leaving.
She's leaving?
Bye!
Alright, so we left Waffle House roughly, what?
An hour and a half.
Hour and a half ago. We are heading out back to Emma's neck of the woods, but somewhere along our travels, we're going to try some Crumbl Cookies. I've never had them. Crumbl Cookies! It brought boosted our energy levels because it's raining here in Illinois and it is just...
It's been a long week.
It's been dreary. Yes, it's been dreary. It's a long week, but we're gonna make this happen.
Everything? He's like, what? What?
Hey, buddy.
Buddy, buddy. Gotta say hi to everybody. Hi, buddy! Hey! Doesn't care about me.
he's like I had company. All right, so I lied. Crumbl Cookies is not what's coming up next, although it is on the horizon. But we are going to be visiting a favorite
Taco
haunt.
Bell. Well,
Taco Bell. Bell. Taco Bell. Bell. Taco Bell is a firm favorite of ours. As you remember from last year's trip in Nashville, we went to have Boozy Baja Blast.
Boozy Taco Bell?
Boozy Taco Bell. And now, of course, since we're rounding the end of our trip, we have to make one stop for Taco Bell.
Damn, Dylan really is fucking
out. I mean, usually that's what I
listen,
would
do. Listen, go in or go oh, home. All right, so we arrived at our last record stop for this trip, and that is Younger Than Yesterday Records. This is in Peoria, in Illinois, and I am quite excited. Bittersweet since it's the last one.
Yeah.
But
and no Jenna.
It's gonna be yeah, and there's no Jenna.
No Jenna.
No Jenna. But we miss Jenna. Let's end this on a high.
Yeah.
So you know that this shop has got to be great when the Destroyer album cover makes up the record store sign.
That's how you do good business.
I think this trip wrapped up well. Did it?
Yeah, it 100% did it? Wrapped up. Yep, we did good.
I'm new.
Yes. Everybody's
going to
be like,
yo,
what?
Who that? So, Emma, do you want to do the honors and introduce
Sure, this is Cody, my boyfriend.
Hey,
that's all a lie. This is actually Jenna in a man suit.
We got her back.
I don't know, what does Jenna
normally
say?
Hey guys! I love McCartney!
It's a gorilla in a monkey suit!
This Marvin Gaye record that I finally found, had to get it.
Chatty daddy!
I do all the jazz! Eclectic!
If you ever find yourself in Peoria, 8 Vinyl Low recommendation. Check out Younger Than Yesterday. This guy's awesome and this store is amazing.
Hell yeah.
Are you sure it's an 8 Vinyl Low recommendation?
It is
an
official.
Are you really, Emma?
Everybody.
Are you really, Emma?
The first official 8 Vinyl Low recommendation.
The first?
The first official.
As if Cheap Trick wasn't before that.
You heard it here first. First official.
First official.
So, as you can tell by my reaction, this was the icing on the cake. But obviously, we did leave with other things, and once we get squared
no,
up,
we didn't.
What's that?
What?
We didn't buy anything.
Nobody.
No money was spent. But once we get squared back at Emma's, we're gonna showcase what we got. And now we've made it to Crumbl Cookies.
Crumbl.
All right, it's the inaugural bite. Nice and warm.
Dylan's first Crumbl cookie.
Is it crumbling in your mouth?
That's a cookie right there.
It's a cookie.
That's a cookie.
But, you know, we got frosted Pop-Tart, peanut butter and jelly, and the lemon. So, had to get it all.
I got nothing.
Oh, really?
Yep.
One of each?
One of each.
One of each.
You're going to love it.
Beautiful.
You're going to love all of it.
Brownie looks delicious.
I came close to getting the brownie. Came
peanut
close.
Butter and jelly, not quite my forte.
It'll be mine.
Right?
That's what mine. I said. It looks so good.
Lemon.
The lemon.
Double fudge. Yeah. Caramel, like
you guys
coffee.
You guys the toffee one?
Nah.
What happened?
The cutter. They have a cutter.
No, we didn't get a cutter. We'll just pick.
There's one with a baby Pop-Tart.
Yeah.
Wait, let's see that Pop-Tart.
Look at it. That's so cute.
Yeah.
He's amused with the baby Pop-Tart.
All right. Rat out of the cellar. It's an original. Excited about that.
Killer.
Wings over America. That's a you, Jenna. She talks it up all the time.
That's a great line.
And then One of These Nights by the Eagles on a blue label.
Hell yeah.
That's what it says.
So it's a reissue.
I don't believe.
Yeah.
Alright.
And we got this cool box.
Yeah.
This cool box.
Hey, makes carrying them a lot easier.
Blondie Sunday Girl EP, the record store day reissue. This one's one Mike found. The season 2 soundtrack, Stranger Things. This is the score for that.
That's cool.
I just need a score for season 1 now, so really pumped. The Hall of Fox 3. And the big 3, those are the Mamas and the Papas connections. If you know, you know. Ian Hunter, All American Alien Boy. I've been looking for this one for a while. Got some ABBA. Love It First Sting by the Scorpions, Japanese Ooh, pressing. Cool. And then because I'm a huge Queen fan, A Time for Heroes, this has Brian May connection, so I had to have it. Yeah, Michael.
Mr. Michael. All right, I got myself a German pressing of King Creole by Elvis Presley, one of his early movie soundtracks. Right there. I got 2 cassettes, finishing off the trifecta, the holy three of the Mannheim Steamroller Christmas albums, the original 3, with Fresh Air Christmas and Christmas in the Air. I have the very first one sealed currently at the moment that Thomas Pelham sent me back in the day, but yep, good stuff there. And then I got this. This is Ricky Nelson's very first album. Not to be confused with Cheap Trick in any way, shape, or form. When I got my grandfather's collection, this is one of his records that he had that only had the album jacket and no record itself. So I near broke down in tears when I saw this. I don't remember if he had a stereo pressing or a mono pressing. I have the jacket I can look at home, but this is an original mono. So I was very excited to find that.
Okay.
His turn.
Okay. So Cheap Trick connection. Now, if you've watched me before, which I'm assuming at this point you have.
Who are you?
Who?
Who are you?
Who's Emma?
Emma from 8 Bottle.
Who the heck are you?
Who is that? So, this is Fuse. Again, right, this is the band that Rick Nielsen and Tom Peterson of Cheap Trick were in pre-Cheap Trick. I already have 3 different copies of this album. However, I had to grab it because it is still sealed. So it's one of those things with Cheap Trick, I will be a never-ending completist. If it's something I don't have, even if I have it and it's sealed, whatever it is, I need it. These people understand.
Can you tell what label it is based on any markings? If it's yellow or...
Yeah, if it's the yellow or the orange, or yellow. Yeah, which I have both, so I don't know which one this would be. If it was yellow, that'd be cool. But I wouldn't know really how... I guess I could compare, maybe.
It's like Schrodinger's record.
Yeah. I guess I'll try to compare the jacket and see if there's what. It didn't smell like Zeppelin.
It didn't smell like Zeppelin.
But it's a great album. And Rick Nielsen. Anyway. Finally, I know Marie can...
Somebody needed attention.
This video was sponsored
by Xander.
Hey, buddy.
Queen 2. I needed to pick up Queen on this trip, and I was specifically waiting to find this one. I know Dylan came across it. He picked up the copy that I saw. I wanted to pick this up.
I picked up the same pressing as that, too.
Yeah, it's whatever.
Yeah, it's
2008 Hollywood.
Yes. But excited to have that. You'll see this again here in a second, but both Dylan and I went in, and I'm sure he'll tell you more about this, the Dennis Wilson Bamboo Caribou Sessions Record Store Day. How many years ago was it? Well, it says 2017.
Yeah.
2017 Record Store Day, so I'll let him talk more about this because I know he'll talk that up. This is something that I haven't seen before, and I figured that Blondie would have albums out, but I've never seen this before. So, Blondie Chaplin. Just a self-titled, it looks like. I'm excited to listen to this. Obviously, his voice and his guitar work is fantastic. So, grab that. And then also finishing off my ZZ Top collection, we have El Loco. And then Rio Grande Mud. This was the Rhino Start Your Off Right 2018 issue of this. And then finally, a Stone Cold Classic with Mick Taylor, John Mayall's Blues Breakers, Crusade. And the reason why I grabbed this one is because it is in mono and was put out by Sundays, I believe they did this. No? Yeah, Sundays. So, yeah.
All right, what did I get? So, as you saw, I came across the holy shit item, and I was going to put back everything else that I had in my hands, but I said, you know what? I'm feeling celebratory. I bought everything else that was in my hand, plus more. So, starting off with these two unofficial pressings of Pink Floyd's Pipe at the Gates of Dawn, Salsa Full of Secrets. I love these albums so much. Yes, I already have official mono and stereo reissues, but it doesn't hurt to have more. And they all. What's
King
that?
King of the Boots.
King of the Boots. These also do come on colored vinyl as well. Sandra, do you like this? You like it?
Which one?
Which he one? Said it smells like Pink Floyd.
Which one?
He's indecisive.
He keeps going to that one.
Which one?
He keeps going to
Piper.
You like
Salsa Full. Good choice.
Piper, yeah.
I couldn't tell if it was in which hand.
And these also do come on cool colored vinyl as well, so these are pretty cool. Just like Emma had showed, Dennis Wilson Bamboo, the Caribou Sessions. This comprises of recordings that were going to be a planned follow-up to Pacific Ocean Blue, but never came to fruition. Dennis passed away, so this kind of brings together the various recordings from that era. Moving onward, I had this in my hands, I think at Euclid, and then I put it down because I bought other stuff, but when I saw it, I was like, I have to get it, but also it's because of the Illinois connection. This is Cheap Trick's We're All Right. Filling out my modern Cheap Trick collection. I think I have every one of their recent records that's been coming out.
Bigs and Crazy Hello?
Yes.
We're All Right in Another World.
Yeah, so pretty much filling in all the gaps there. So happy to get this.
Do you see the Kiss on the back?
Of course, yes. Can-Am's Tour 77 because Cheap Trick opened up for Kiss in 77. Just look at the lyrics of Surrender. Moving onward, this is a cool variant. So this right here is Ace Frehley's Spaceman. This is a different cover variant. You can see he's in the orange spacesuit, and this does come on orange vinyl. I have like a standard pressing of it, which has like him in the silver outfit on silver vinyl. But when I saw this, I was like, you know what? Since I'm into variants, it's nice to have this. And as you may have seen already, so I'm gonna wrap this trip on the biggest, most coolest symphonic note. It is Kiss Symphony Alive 4. I have been wanting this for my collection for the longest time. Literally, I said early on in this trip that if I was to come across two Kiss grails, it would be Sonic Boom and Kiss Symphony Alive 4. Did get the unofficial Sonic Boom, but this right here is an official 2003 pressing, limited to 10,000 copies. This is copy 1,548. And I honestly am just having a great time just looking at it. So
I don't think I believed you when he said you were gonna get it.
Oh, I had to, and also for the price too. I mean, granted, you did see you saw the price.
Yeah.
You see the price. Cover's a little beat up. Spine has some tattered wear on it, but the vinyl itself is in very good shape.
Is there
so,
a gatefold?
Yes, here I'll showcase it.
You gotta say,
Yeah. Good shit. So. Yeah, all good stuff. So, ended this trip on the greatest note possible.
Hey, Emma. It's Rick. How you doing? So, happy birthday coming up here. You're going to be 25. Holy cow. That's a good age. I'm trying to think what I did when I was 25. Oh, I played in a band. Oh, yeah. Let's see. This is from me and Cody. This is your really special. And I heard you're a fan of Cheap Trick. For me, I don't know. He didn't give me enough instructions. So, you're coming to see us in Decatur? All right, it's gonna be cool. Oh, I heard if it was the 70s, you'd get groupie. Cool. And I'm gonna see you a couple days after your birthday in Decatur, Illinois. I played last night with ZZ Top. And 2 days before that, we played with Rod Stewart. On Friday, Saturday, and then Sunday, we played with ZZ Top. Or maybe it's Thursday, Friday.
It's a long cameo.
But, oh yeah, I know it's your birthday coming up. So, be cool. And, let's see. I can't think of anything great to say. Except Emma. That's cool, man. There's two letters the same in there. Like Dax, E-A-X-X. And Rick. That's not right. All right, so Emma and Cody, happy birthday. I'll get my voice back before then. All right, see you there. Bye-bye.
Oh my God, I hate you so much.
Who was that? I couldn't tell.
Rick Nielsen. Rick fucking, oh, Rick fucking Nielsen.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. I
figured
you'd like that.
Yeah. I'm crying.
That's going
badass.
Hell yeah. Oh my God. I'm shaking.
Well, at first I thought it was Cody doing, like, since we're
I thought he was out. Too. Oh, thank you.
Xander, you can't go in here. This isn't.
Blocker.
She's gonna start crying again.
No.
She was crying when Jenna left. She made me cry when Jenna left.
I cried when
Jenna
left.
You're gonna have to
I'm
be with her
tomorrow
yet. If you can help it.
Huh?
Tomorrow when she drops them off, you let you should tag along. Or drive, if you can.
I was about to hug you, and then I realized I'm going home with you. No, not yet. Not yet, they have to turn and go. You ready?
I'm not saying anything.
They're probably like, what the hell is she doing? Oh, jeez.
You're gonna make yourself cry.
See you on the other side.
You're trying to make me cry.
All right, guys, it is Saturday morning. We are on our way to O'Hare. Got about 2.5 hours to go. And Jersey boys are flying home. Thanks to our chauffeur. Our wonderful, wonderful chauffeur as well as host. So
Emma's a beautiful human.
That's right. Homeward bound we go.
See it? Give it a little pop. You turn this little guy right here, you're ready to go. Come here. You take the cart, you say, hey, look at this, regular cash my ass. You take that, you pop that in like that, okay? Pop it in, it's a gorgeous day, you don't have to sit in the cart. You're removing the cart, you plug it in, you're ready to go. You grab one of these, bada bing, bada boom, pop that in, and let it ride.
Okay, but fill it up regular cash, please.
What?
Fill it up regular cash.
As soon as you are able, on the night I am willing to make the break that we are on the brink of. My cup is on the table. My love is feeling. Oh, it is here for you to take and drink of. So if you're tired,
all right, so Emma just dropped us off at O'Hare. It is now just the Jersey boys. And now we just play a game of hurry up and wait for our flight back to Jersey. Hell yeah.
I love you, Marika.
All right, so after a 30-minute delay from boarding, we made it. We'll be right back. got back to Mike's truck. We are now heading over to his place, and we're kind of reliving some old glory days in St. Louis because we do have some Taco Bell for the road. Taco Bell round two, I should say.
Taco Bell.
It's gonna keep us fueled for the late night that we have.
Oh, ain't that the truth.
All right, just got back to Mike's. I'm in my car. It's 11 o'clock at night. I got 2.5 hours down south where I'm based at. Luckily, when I was on the plane ride, I had myself a nice cup of coffee, so I'm quite jolted and ready to take on this journey home. But I'm gonna stop chit-chatting because home awaits. Alright guys, it is almost 2 a.m. and I finally made it home, and boy oh boy, what a week I have witnessed with the people that I am so honored and glad to call my best friends. Of course, those being the youngest members of the VC. Honestly, it's so funny now in retrospect to think back, because when I think back to when we first met up together in Nashville, there was all the excitement that was building up to us meeting for the first time. And then, of course, you know, given that we got along so well upon first meeting, there was a real sense of sadness of saying goodbye. And with this year, it was almost like we were able to kind of pick up where we left off at and just go with it. And while we were able to do that, I feel that I was able to become much closer with, you know, each individual person as themselves, as well as the group as a unit. And honestly, like what you saw in the footage, you know, that is how we genuinely are around each other. There is a true sense of camaraderie. You know, we love each other dearly. We are very supportive of each other. You know, we're into, you know, we're all into our own, you know, type of thing in terms of, you know, genres and artists. But yet there's also a lot of stuff that we tend to gel with. And I think that's one of the great factors that attracts us together. And, you know, of course, there's always the case of, you know, sad goodbyes that were said towards the end of the trip. But just given how, you know, we were, you know, so pumped for this, you know, for this year's trip in St. Louis, we have already been discussing what we're going to do next year. And you guess you'll just have to wait and see what we have coming up in stock for what's to come in the next year or so. And it is going to be absolutely phenomenal. I'm personally very excited for it, and I absolutely cannot wait for it to happen. So Marikin, Emma, Jenna, Mike, and Jared, thank you so much for such a fantastic week. I absolutely love you guys, and I cannot wait to see you in a year's time. Maybe sooner. There might be, you know, maybe a small meetup perhaps sprinkled in somewhere. You never really know. It's easy, you know, for those that do live relatively, you know, I guess states, you know, close to each other. And then of course, you know, for Mike and I being completely on the East Coast, it's kind of tricky, but hopefully something could be in the cards soon for a small get together. But regardless, we have a big yearly meetup to look forward to. So thank you guys so much. I hope that this documentary was enjoyable for you guys. And I hope that you can get past the small segment, because like I said, it's 2 a.m. and I am gonna sleep in. So like I always say, keep the record spinning.